scientific name, what is it? Is it the genus, I think? For a willow tree? Yeah, it's the genius of the willow tree. As for why rain? Oh, she pulled me on that one. Hi, rain. Hey, Jess. I woke up about 20 minutes ago. Don't worry, I just kind of passed out. And it's like, oh yeah. Loud music. Yeah, the... Ah. To be fair, I wasn't talking very loud a second ago either. I'm pretty sure OBS has just been acting up lately. In theater yesterday, and now it's like, okay, but like, this artwork is really fucking cute. I know nothing about this game. I just know the artwork's cute. I also know I am no longer a witch in training. I am an alchemist. My glasses creak, jeez. Now then, what is a salix and why is it winged? I am a salix. So fun fact, salix is the genus of a willow tree. we don't come pre-named, I can't. I was just very into botany at that point. Okay. Yeah, I don't know very much about this game. I just know, Bad End Theater was really good. And it's a visual novel, so it's gonna be, like, a lot of reading. There's also... here? I don't know if I want to actually check these right now or not. So we'll come back to that later. You're a flying plant. We can go with that, sure. In a peaceful town of magic users, there's a shop that only sells ordinary non-magical candies. Atelier Sweets. The owner is known as the Candy Alchemist, a firm believer in science as the superior art. Proud and stubborn, she continues to make magnificent candies in order to prove her case. But a magical surprise waits in her basement workshop. What's this thing? Good morning, how are you? Did she make a person? Wait. Fine. I am also fine. Steve, can you come down here, like, now? I would like it if you told me your name. I would tell you mine, but I was not given one. Syrup. Pastel, hurry up! You are Syrup. It is very nice to meet you. I hope we can be friends. Yeah, that's not happening. Pastel, get down here already! Syrup, it is very important that we get along. You stay away from me. I want you out of my lab right now. What is this you are holding? What's it look like? It's candy. You are eating it? Yep. That's the whole point of candy. To get eaten. I see. Then, please eat. Wait, is this game Twitch appropriate? All of a sudden, I'm like, wait. What? No, you weirdo! But you have to. It is my purpose. Ask Candy. Enjoy your work, Adris. I am doing a quick Google search to see what this game is actually about. Wait a second. Have to run some errands. Be back soon. Don't worry, nothing explicit. Okay. Enjoy your errands. Drive safe. Be careful. In that case, do not eat the candy girl. I'm not eating you. Is there a problem? Please put me in your mouth. Oh, dear. It's about time, Pastille. Make her stop. I do. I think Bad in Theater definitely got me hooked on this art. Apparently this is like the order that the creator said to do it in. But you don't necessarily have to do them in order. But that's why I started with this one. Technically Bad in Theater should be near the bottom, but you know, whatever, it's too late for that. We can play Bad in Theater again. I promise I taste good. Here, just start with the finger. I said no! I'm not gonna eat a person, that's too weird. I am not a person, I am candy. You said the whole point of candy is to get eaten. Howdy! Hello! Welcome, welcome. How are you tonight? Hey, why don't you just eat her then? Hello, I am Salix. We are playing Syrup in the Ultimate Sweet because I played Bad in Theater yesterday and it was fantastic. Doing good, and you? I'm glad you're doing good. Oh, thank you for the follow. Gee, I'm admittedly still half asleep because I ended up falling asleep earlier and I woke up like a half hour ago and decided, hey, I'm not doing Call to the Lamb today. I'm not doing Digimon. I am going to look up more from this indie artist. Because I really enjoyed Bad in Theater. It's really good. It's not all pixel art like Bad in Theater, but that's okay. It's still cute. Like, look at this. Look how cute they are. Thanks. we'll do a couple of routes here and see how we're feeling on if we want to switch. Sus. Look. Because she's not regular candy, I don't want to eat any magic candy that acts like it's human. The art is pretty cute, right? Like, if you look up, who told me about it yesterday? Somebody told me yesterday, and Kay just mentioned it too. They look up NomnomNami. And so I did, and she's got a few different games. And it's like, ah! Why that candy? It's like, look, man, I couldn't tell you. We're just going with it. It's candy, so I don't know why she's naked. Kind of reminds me a bit of Luminous. Yeah, maybe a bit. Yeah. I can see it. If I did not act human, would you eat me? Oh my god. I'm also mildly concerned. Nope. It's too late. I'm never eating you ever. Got it? No! Hey, don't give up. Maybe she'll change her mind one day. What the hell? Don't encourage her. Whose side are you on? I will not give up. I will get along with Syrup. If you want to get along so badly, stop telling me to eat you. Okay, I do feel kind of bad though. I'm not very good at voices. I want to get better at that this year though. Because I've got way too many visual novels, so I might as well play some of them, right? I still do something about this. Me? Yeah, you. It's your fault she's in here. What do you mean? I know exactly where this girl came from. You do? That rotten witch made her to torment me. This is all her stupid elaborate prank. You forgot to lock the place up last night, and look what happened. Oh, Yeah, that's really what happened. Whoops. My apologies.
Whatever, just hurry up and get her out of here. I've got work to do.
Yes, the important work of eating me.
I said that, Taco.
She's not gonna drop that, is she? Look, if a candy girl tells you to eat her, who are you to refuse? If it looks like a human, and it talks like a human, and it acts like a human, but it's made out of candy, it's not cannibalism, right?
Syrup, you are going the wrong way.
Hold on. You'll never be able to get along with her if you keep telling her what to do.
Really?
Yeah, can't you tell? She doesn't like it very much. You have to find out what she likes.
Castile, I can't help but notice that doesn't sound like you're trying to get rid of her. In fact, it sounds like the complete opposite.
All right, Master, I will find out what she...
Oh, Castile's Master, okay. Master?
Maybe she means Master of the Household?
This is my store, not a house. If anyone's the master, it's me.
Should I have not called you Master? Should I have not called you Master? Master?
The fuck did you do?
Just Pastille is fine.
Master Pastille!
Well, that's close enough.
You! Stop being so friendly with my assistant! And you! I thought I told you to get her out of here!
Come on, Sai. She's not hurting anyone. You're forgetting that it was that witch who made her. Obviously, as a prank or something. Just watch. She'll start wrecking my lap any minute now.
No, the fact that she's calling the other one master kind of that. I'm just saying. I don't think she ever planned on wrecking anything, so.
Are you saying I'm wrong? And that she's here for some other reason?
Well, I don't know. I just think...
You, candy weirdo. Who made you?
That is a secret.
Why are you here then?
To get along with Syrup.
See, harmless.
Shut your face.
Alright.
Wanna know the secret to get along with me?
Yes.
Stay out of my lap!
But... Let's give her some space for now, okay?
Okay.
Why is she only listening to Bastille, stupid candy weirdo? That should tell you something, hon. I'm just saying.
A little while later.
One more batch of these. And... Shoot, I need more... dancing? Guess I'm taking a shopping break.
And every day after the cleaning is done, we take every...
Oh my god, look how cute she is in that uniform.
Then every day after cleaning's done, we take inventory.
Running a store sounds like a lot of work. I have a newfound respect for you, Master Pastille.
What is this? What are you doing?
Oh, sir. I'm teaching her how we run the store.
I am helping.
No. No, no, no. You were supposed to make her leave, not reveal all our trade secrets.
Why did you dress her up like that?
Salix in the art style win. When you find me an artist who can do it.
Would you rather she kept walking around naked? She needs a uniform or she's going to work here.
She's not working here!
I want to work for Syrup. Let's get along.
Cut it out! What are you thinking, Pastille? What if she really was sent here as a spy so that witch can ruin us? It's like you're just handing her our business.
Use the extra help. If she does turn out to be Butterscotch's spy, I'll take full responsibility. So, can we keep her?
She's not a puppy!
Magic candle
Candy golems aren't pets. I said no! I will work hard to earn my stay. I am very skilled with menial tasks. It's true. Did you clean this whole place while you were down there making candy? Look around, it's spotless.
She did do a good job. Even looks brighter than usual. Still don't like it. She's put up such a fight. I kind of want to do that one.
I'm not hiring a spy, and she's not staying here. That's final. Spying is not a friendly thing to do. Exactly, which is why I gotta be proactive here. Taking her back to where she came from. Close up shop and follow me.
Master Pastille, I do not understand one bit.
I'm sorry.
I wish you could stay here too. It'd certainly make things a lot easier.
Oh well.
I feel like a mistake was made.
Cat person? Yahoo! Visitors!
Tell the witch we have something of hers.
What do we have?
She's talking about you.
Is this a candy golem? Looks very well made. Master will be interested.
Yeah, just get her out here.
So bossy, yeah. Echo me, no. Hurry, no. Cat person, yes.
I just lost a question mark. Question mark. Cat person?
Hey, Master! Your old pal, the candy alchemist, is here with something sweet. Yeah.
What? Don't lie to me, Toffee. She'd never bring me anything.
Honest, yeah? Come see for yourself.
There are too many voices going on.
Well. I never thought I'd see the day where the great candy alchemist Syrupy personally brings me candy.
Butterscotch.
Let's see. Oh, a life-size girl-shaped candy. It looks delicious. I am relieved to hear that. I was worried I didn't look tasty since Syrupy refused to eat me.
Cat person? It's alive! Where'd you get your hands on a golem like this?
Quit playing dumb. I know you made her torment and or spy on me.
You think that I?
Yes, well done, Candy Alchemist. You're exactly right. I made this golem myself with my incredibly powerful magic. Are you a cat person, Celix?
Yes and no. I have a humanoid form, as you can see. But originally I was a familiar, so like I was just a magical battery, basically.
I just had a cat, or I took the form of an actual cat. There was a little mishap. We're not going to worry about that right now.
But yes, we'll just go with cat person. It makes it easier.
Meow! Wow, Master! I can't believe you made something so sophisticated without me even noticing!
I'm gonna start talking like this. If I start talking like that, I think... Would I drive myself insane first, or... I think I get somebody else to go mad?
Cat persona tuber. Sounds easy. Like I said, it's much easier than trying to explain, you know? There was just an incident. It's my witch. And a spell kind of going a little bit sideways. Now I can't really hold my form very well. It's fine. It's fine. I'm going to start talking like that. And we're going to see. I would drive myself insane first. Let's be real.
You shush. This is nothing. I can do high level magic in my sleep.
Put it down. It doesn't count if you do it in a dream, yeah.
That's not what I meant, you know it!
Sai, are you sure you want to leave her with these two?
My mind's made up. You think this is going to give me my first ending? On second thought.
No, I think I may have jumped the gun a little on this one. What was I thinking? Coming here and politely returning her wouldn't teach them a lesson at all.
You were really going to give that thing to us, Nya?
Not anymore. I've come to my senses. You probably would have just eaten her in a day anyway.
You cannot savor my sweetness if you eat me all at once. What a waste.
I would have paced myself. Here, I'll show you. Let me try a piece right now. Too bad. You should have thought about that before you left her in my lap as a prank. At least you can always make another one, right?
Yeah, of course I can. Who do you think I am?
Anyway, if you ever pull something like this again, I'm banning you and your stupid cat from my store. Are we clear?
Oh no, but then where will Master get her favorite candies?
You can't ban me! I'll put a hex on you!
Please do not do that. Hexes are not very nice.
Come on, guys. We're going home.
I can't believe she came here just to rub that thing in my face. She's so mean!
You started it by declaring her your rival way back when, yeah?
Shut up, mangy cat!
Yeah, who's the mean one?
Toffee's just like, uh-huh. You want to keep going that way? Okay, sure.
And so, the golem started living with Syrup and Pastel at the Atelier Suites.
Don't ask me what that word is, I'm so sorry.
She became a mascot figure for the shop, boosting sales instantly.
Jelly something. No.
You'll think of something. I have faith in you, Syrup.
What's going on over here? I'm trying to come up with a name for her.
You're naming her? What happened to candy golems aren't pets?
Well, I can't just keep calling her candy weirdo.
Technically, you could.
No, we really should give you a proper name. How about Gumdrop?
Gumdrop? It's a nice name.
I think she likes it.
Yes. If I knew it was Syrup, she would be... I knew if it was Syrup, she would pick something good.
Milk chocolate? Hello, hello. The chocolate brothers are making their entrance. Ooh, and I feel like I need to sneeze.
Excuse me.
Yes, we heard your shop has gotten a lot more interesting as of late, so we just had to pop in.
Hello, welcome to Altier Sweets. Oh, Candy Alchemist, you got sugary golems for sale now? How charming.
But if we're not mistaken, isn't magic necessary in their making? Unless you found a way to create life through your alchemy? I mean, if albedo is anything to go off of. She's her assistant, and I didn't make her.
Oh, mysterious. I am completely taken with her. May I offer you flowers, my lady?
Magic flowers? You are very good, sir.
Can you not do that in here? I don't want your magic dust getting all over my goods. You haven't changed one bit, Candy Alchemist. Our apologies.
Syrup, you should not boss around these kind, well-dressed customers.
Are you sassing me?
It's my store! I'll do what I want!
Would you perhaps be interested in selling this one? She's quite adorable. How much we talking? How much we talking?
I don't know.
What's she worth to you? Depending on the number, I might be interested.
Silence, horrible. Just gave her a name, we are not selling her. If I could not stay here with Syrup, it would be very difficult to complete my goal.
Are you quite certain? We'd like to remind you that money is no object for us.
Sorry, we need her here.
Pastille's like, no. Bad. You just named it, you're not getting rid of it. What a shame. Golems are said to be such excellent servants. We've come to want one of our own. You two can do magic. Make one yourselves.
Oh, no, no.
This is a very high-level spell that requires focused passion. Even our combined power couldn't result in anything close to that.
I'm sure you could get it if you tried.
Not that I know anything about magic.
I didn't make her anything, Cornel.
Well, well, we'll just have to give it a go sometime then, hmm?
Now, I suppose we should purchase something sweet and be on our way. Caramel does sound lovely, doesn't it, brother? I have that. Allow me to assist you at the register.
She's so friendly, isn't she?
I think she overdoes it.
That never keeps customers happy, though.
Hey, Pastille. Is it true not just any old witch can make a golem?
Huh? Well, you don't see very many walking around, so that sounds about right.
Hmm.
Any further your thoughts?
Just wondering what Butterscotch's actual skill level is when it comes to this kind of thing.
You look genuinely surprised to see Gumdrop, but it could have been an act just to throw me off. I don't know anymore.
Well, it's like you said. If Butterscotch didn't make her, then who did?
Seems to listen to you. Do you know where I'm going with that?
Dun dun dun!
No? What?
Oh my god, Syrup, no!
You almost had it. You were so close. You were so close.
Ask her to tell you who her creator is. Since you won't tell me, you're my only hope, dude.
I already asked. But I was training her for work. No luck there, sorry.
Ugh. I get out of her somewhere or another.
Change the subject.
Because it's totally not me. I didn't do it. What? I mean, it's not like she calls me master or anything. What?
I'm surprised to see you out of that basement during store hours. Was there any particular reason for that?
Yeah, I was planning on supervising Gumdrop.
Looking after our new assistant. Hey, Gumdrop!
Do you need something, sir?
Let's do something together. I want to work with you today.
In that case, I am interested in learning about the process of candy making. Could you show me how it is done?
So you can steal my recipes?
At all. I only thought it would make a nice bonding experience. But if you do not wish to...
I guess I don't mind. Just know I've got my eye on you. I'm definitely going to find out what your deal is.
Bonding, what's up? Huzzah!
Sitting at candy making for candy? Is that cannibalism?
Right. Well, you two have fun.
Then, after you pour in the syrup, you let it boil for a while. The temperature is different depending on what kind of candy you're making.
Syrup is the secret ingredient? How fun!
It only becomes a problem when she starts eating. Does she start eating it? There's no secret ingredients. It's just regular hard candy.
It is still exciting. What comes next?
Flavor. And you pour it all out, add some citric acid and color, and make it into whatever shape you want before it cools and hardens. Rolling it around is kind of the fun part. Here, when this batch is ready, I'll give you some gloves so you can join in.
Ba-da-da-da. The singing to the candy make it taste better. I will join you. La la la.
No, singing has nothing to do with it. It's just kind of a habit I have since usually no one's down here with me. I see that blush.
I think your candies appreciate it anyway.
That's enough rolling. Let's wait for them to cool off. Should be ready now. Here, try it. You're giving the candy golem candy to eat. Are we sure this doesn't constitute as cannibalism?
Like, just out of curiosity.
Just, you know, maybe?
Wow, mythic.
Actually, wait. Would eating this make you a... I'm not the only one questioning this.
I was not made with the ability to taste things, so I will pass.
Huh. What other senses are you missing?
Taste is related to smell, which I am also incapable of.
You sound pretty cheery for someone missing out on some major sensory experiences, Stumpdrop.
Yeah,
yuck. Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
I also do not feel pain, so being a candy person does have its advantages.
Huh. I guess it's just a matter of perspective, then. I totally didn't just get those backwards, but... So, why'd you want to make candy with me if you can't enjoy any of it? Was it just a spy on me after all?
I did it. I did enjoy it. Now I have a better understanding of where I came from.
I didn't make you, though?
Well, still.
I just got done bathing a fully coated coin. Ooh! That must have been fun. Maybe. Your parts were actually made by me? That witch just bought enough candy for me, so it's definitely possible.
Would you like to know for sure? You could always try it, but...
She's never gonna drop that, is she? So much hair and still damn in places after an hour.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
I'm not even it's been a while since I've had a golden retriever or a golden lab. Like, I know those things are hairy animals. She's never gonna drop. But she's very big on the, hey, eat me, eat me, eat me. Trying to trick me into eating you again? It's not gonna happen. It doesn't matter what you're made of. What I really want to know is who put you together.
I cannot tell you that. I am sorry.
Figures. We're done here. Give that tray of candies to Pastille. I'm going out for a bit.
You're up.
Oh, she suddenly came out here. Toffee, what do we do? Is that count as a witch? She's been trying to get Syrup to eat her from the start. So... Butterscotch. Cat! What are you doing creepily lurking outside my store?
It really hurts my feelings when you don't remember my name, yeah?
Don't dodge the question, and don't try to run away!
Who's running away? This is a public road. We're well within our rights to loiter here.
We came to see your golem, yeah. No, I didn't. I was just about to come in and show off something incredible I made. Get ready for some... Wait. Toffee's my favorite character. Oh my god. Maybe it's just the cat girl relatability. It's the cat person relatability. But Toffee's my favorite. I love this. Get ready for some disappointing yet. You only came along to stand by me and make your stupid puns and just go home. I'm really proud of this. Cute.
Ta-da! Her name is Matilda. Now see, we both have delicious magical miracle steward ability.
Oh, I just thought it was at all. You're joking, right?
She may not be as big and lifelike as your golem, which I also made, but this one's got twice the charm if you ask me. She doesn't move as much either, but, well... Now that you've seen the merits of Matilda, I'm sure you can't resist the urge to trade golems with us.
Ah, so that's why you're here. You get Gumdrop back. Well, too bad, she's working for me now.
That's not fair! You said it yourself! I'm the one who made her! She's my thing!
Listen, I'm not trading Gumdrop for your dummy candy doll, so quit hanging around here and scaring off paying customers.
So if we can come in and make a purchase, you'll forgive us?
What you do to words is unforgivable. Me ouch.
Sweet Matilda, you've fallen to pieces. I guess the only option left is to eat you. Then buy some more candy.
Fine, come in. Just don't try to steal Gumdrop while I'm not looking. I don't want to have to walk all the way back to your house to bring her back.
Of course not. That would be candy napping.
Yeah.
Oh, it is the witch and kitty cat from before.
Oh, there she is. Such beautiful gummy skin. And oh, if I could just try a bite of that hair.
You haven't already? That's odd, considering you claim that you made her. That's because I had to send her in flawless condition. I showed a lot of restraint, you know, but it paid off. She's perfect. Now Master is at her limit. You should let her have a taste before she loses it, Nia. Absolutely not. You can have any other candy in here except gumdrop.
How cruel. You just want to keep her all for yourself, don't you?
I'll put it up with it for now.
Just don't forget that golem actually belongs to me.
Yeah, enough whining. Just buy something and get out. Don't get any of your gross magic or drool in my stock.
My magic isn't gross. You should take this drool as a compliment.
Yeah.
Come on, Toffee, let's blow this popsicle stand.
Next time those two come by, we should really just pretend we're closed. The next morning.
Gumdrop, what are you doing in my lab?
Oh, Syrup. I'm organizing your bookshelf.
What? Why are you even doing up right now? The store doesn't open for another few hours.
I do not require sleep.
Anyway,
you shouldn't come down here without permission and start moving my things around. I don't like it.
Oh, may I come in and...
You already did.
But whatever, I guess it's fine.
Syrup, I have noticed a trend with the books in your personal library.
Oh yeah? What's that?
They're all fairy
porn. Wow, okay. Hey, thanks.
Only one book is abnormal. It is the only one with reference to magic.
Magic? Throw it out. Wait, isn't this?
Oh yeah, it's an old family cookbook. My grandma wrote it.
I am sensing high levels of nostalgia. Syrup's cold heart has been softened by memories from days long past.
Yeah.
See this right here? When I was a kid, making this was my dream.
The ultimate sweet, a legendary confection said to have only been crafted once before by the greatest alchemist in the world.
Flavor rating, 100 stars. Shelf life, eternal. To those who partake in the sweet are blessed with great fortune. Upon consumption, a temporary enlightened state is attained, and you find yourself crying for reasons you cannot place.
Obtaining the ingredients for the ultimate sweet require both magical talent and mastery of science, making it exceedingly difficult, if not utterly impossible, for one person to create on their own.
The ultimate sweet? Is it yummy?
Only the most delicious thing to ever exist. I used to tell Pastille I was going to make it one day so he could taste it. But like the book says, the main ingredient is impossible to find without magic. I guess I kind of gave up on it.
Master Pastille wanted to eat this?
Yeah, a long time ago. He probably forgot about it by now.
Syrup, we should make it.
Like I said, I had to give up on it. Can't make it without magic, so I don't want to.
But we can ask... which can help us?
Not happening.
You should not give up on your dream. This is our chance to work together and get along even more.
You're always going on about that. Are you obsessed with being friends or something?
Precisely.
Alright, Candy Weirdo. Let's find a way to make the ultimate sweet. Without magic.
Good. And while Master Pastille eats it, you can eat me.
I love her. I love her.
I said it 1,000 times, I am not eating you!
Disappointment. Come on then. We'll need to do some research before we can go out gathering ingredients.
Choco library.
Alright, keep an eye out for any encyclopedias about plants.
Any alchemist? What a surprise.
And you brought your new assistant! To what do we owe the pleasure?
Perhaps you've come to sell your golem to us against your friend's wishes.
Gumdrop is adorable. She's great.
And like, look at the little, like, if you actually look close enough, like, she's got little stars in her eyes. Like, ugh, she's precious.
Syrup, say it is not.
Actually, I didn't expect to run into you here. So, no.
You didn't expect it?
Our family owns this library, dear.
You ought to have known that. Certainly, you've lived here long enough by now.
We're almost always dilly-dallying, so if you're looking for something in particular, allow us to direct you to the proper shelves.
How convenient. We need information on a certain plant, so if you could help speed the process, we'd appreciate it.
Glad to be of assistance, Candy Alchemist. We look forward to tasting whatever it is you're synthesizing.
All of the plants in this book look so interesting. I would like to see some of them in person one day.
It's got stuff from all over the world. You'd have to travel pretty far to even see half of these.
Traveling with Syrup! We would definitely become great friends if we went on a long journey together.
Hopefully for this thing we won't have to go too far.
Oh, this page. This is exactly what we need.
Frosted Vanilla? A rare species of vanilla orchard that miraculously thrives in frozen environments. This magical plant will melt in ordinary water when removed from colder climates, but its fruit can last up to 3 days depending on storage temperature. So we're going to the Dragon Spine. Because it inexplicably grows from cryotonic soil, it is believed by some cultures to be born from the tears of an ice goddess. So we're going to the Dragon Spine! According to this, we should be able to find it on Mount Syrupy, but...
What?
It's impossible. We definitely need magic to even have a chance at finding it. Please let dragons find anything but that. Not the cold, we just got done with the cold.
So we will ask a witch to help us. I'm sure Miss Butterscotch would...
Absolutely not.
Then, how do you plan to get the final ingredient?
Look, it's not gonna happen. That mountain is home to a ton of monstrous beasts, and it's freezing cold. I'd probably die if I went on a mountain. So we're going to Dragon Spine.
I shall accompany you, Syrup.
You wouldn't be able to move in those temperatures. You made out of candy, remember?
But I know. I'll be fine if you keep me warm. Just put me in your mouth and...
Stop. We're not going. Who would even go to such crazy extents just to make some special dessert? Kind of a waste of effort, if you ask me.
You're right, Syrup. It is silly. Let's quit.
Are you angry?
Nope. Master Pastel will not even know that he missed anything. It really was not a waste, just a waste of time.
Gumdrop. Absorbed in thought, Syrup takes her time returning home.
Was it worth it to deny her friend what would surely be the most delicious treat in the world, just to hang on to her stubborn pride? She had never thought about it before. Asking a witch for help seemed impossible for a variety of reasons. But soon, she might just have to.
Oh, Sai, where have you been all morning?
Out.
Fair enough. If you need him, Gopdrop, would you ask her to run the register for a while? This has been picking up, so I actually need the help.
She isn't here?
I thought she was with you.
No, I might know where she went. Just keep working, don't worry about it, I'll be right back.
Not like I have any other choice. Oh well.
Meow wow, it's the Candy Alchemist again!
I need your help. You're the only people I can ask. I don't want Pastel to know about this.
Uh-oh?
What is it? Something serious?
You have to bury a body.
No, Gumdrop ran off. I think she went to Mount Syrupy to get a rare ingredient for this thing she wants to make. Whatever, you guys don't need to know the details.
Ah, so that's where she was going. I saw her pass by and wondered, Nia.
What? Why didn't you stop her?
I greeted her, but the girl was on a mission. She barely even told me where she went. Where she was padding off to. She just pointed to the mountain and said, that way.
You should know I have a policy of never asking too many questions. Curiosity only leads her to trouble for folks like me.
This cat.
Mountain. At least that confirms she was definitely going in the direction. I wonder how far she got.
Do you think something bad happened to her? What if she got eaten along the way?
If it's too cold, she won't be able to move. If she doesn't come home, Pastilla will get all upset, probably blame me for it. He wants me to make the special recipe for him. And if he knew she was only trying to get the last ingredient because I said I wouldn't go, well, I'd blame me too.
Say no more! I will help you find dear sweet gumdrop.
But only if you give me a taste of whatever you're planning on making.
This was a terrible. No, we gotta get gumdrop back. Ugh, fine. New magic anyway, so I might as well use you. One taste. That's it.
We'll negotiate the terms later. Let's get your candy back.
How about you, cat? Feel like climbing a mountain with us?
No, thanks. That place is all snow and dogs. I can barely stand the thought of it. I'm a silly dweller at heart, yeah.
Just wait right here for us, Toffee. We'll be back before you know it.
Be safe.
Yeah.
Oh. I didn't want them to kill.
I hate the cold.
It's not that bad, but I guess it's different for someone not protected by magic.
How about I bury you in the snow to see what your magical protection does against that?
Oh, my dear candy alchemist, are we supposed to be partners on this little quest? You can't talk that way to a party member. Let's just get along.
You too.
Huh? Gumdrop's always insisting she wants to get along with me. Why do I need to get along with anyone? Why can't I just do things on my own way without annoying people trying to befriend me?
Annoying?
I didn't say we should be friends. I just think it'd be best if we cooperate. Fair enough. This place can be pretty dangerous. I've read there's ferocious wolves that all gang up on you and repeat the shreds.
Wolves? I'm not afraid of wolves.
How about a whole pack? You think you could take them out with your magic?
Easily.
Oh, really? You're trembling.
It's just because of the cold.
Hey, what's that ahead?
Is it a wolf? A monster? Syrup, do something!
I think we found Gumdrop. She's completely frozen. I wonder if she's conscious right now?
Hey, candy idiot! I told you this would happen if you came up here. You're lucky we found you.
So someone was looking for...
Butterscotch, you're being rude.
I've been watching this golem for a while, wondering if anyone would show up to fetch her.
Huh, you live around here?
I actually came to find a special plant. Do you think you could take her to your house and thaw while we go get it? I promise we won't be too long.
Psst, sir, what if she eats her?
Ducks don't really have a sweet tooth, right?
I prefer meat.
See, nothing to worry about. This way's a lot more convenient than taking her all the way home than have to hike all the way back up here for one little plant. I don't mind taking her in. Being her frozen in place for so long is kind of sad.
We don't even know who you are. Why should we trust you with something as valuable as living candy?
Treat.
Huh?
It's my name. Now we're acquainted.
All right, Butterscotch. Do you have any of the other problems or can we get going now?
No, I'm glad that's all settled. Let's go find your rare ingredient, whatever it was, and go home.
Sorry, she's more of a cat person.
Syrup, right? I smell a pretty powerful spell on that witch. Is she really okay to be up here wasting that much magic?
Spell?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I guess ordinary humans can't sense that kind of thing. Plain to say it to me.
Anyway, it smells like something useless. Tell her to concentrate on survival. I want to be able to return your golem later.
Sure. Thanks.
After receiving directions from Treat, the pair continue up the mountain. Syrup felt at ease knowing Gumdrop was safe, but Butterscotch seemed to be having a rough time. Things only got worse as they ran into trouble.
I'll be kind of lurking ye. You go do what you need to do.
Menacing.
What are you doing, scared off with your magic? This monster!
You turned it pink?
Almond!
Either way, I guess it worked. Lucky break. Butterscotch. You wouldn't happen to have, like, a curse on you or anything, right?
Rude, I am not cursed. I'm completely fine. I just lost focus and messed up. It happens to everyone.
Your teeth are clattering. What happened to your magic protection against the cold?
It's windy, and maybe I'm not as strong as I thought. Are you...
Do you want my coat?
What? No, you need it, don't you?
I can make a sacrifice if it means you'll talk normally again.
Thanks, you're not as mean as I thought.
Time to go! Syrupy and Butterscotch escape into a frozen cave. The witch hastily seals the entrance with ice, forcing the wolves to abandon their chase. Exhausted, the pair take a while to search for us. Hey, you alright?
No, this is awful! I'm trying to stay home with Toffee where it's safe and warm!
Well, at least we should be able to find what we're looking for in here. This is the exact environment Frosted Cremilla thrives in. You can just chill here if you want. I'm going further in.
How dare you make a joke like in a time like this? You're as bad as Toffee. Syrup, wait! Don't leave me alone!
Whoa. Yep, found it.
Jerk. How could you leave me behind like that?
Oh, is this what we came for? Yeah, I just need to grab some of the fruit and we can go home.
Good. Grab a ton so we never have to come back.
I feel like taking too many is going to be a bad idea. I don't have use for this many. If I need more, we've got experience now. It won't be nearly as much trouble for us a second time, right?
You'd want to go through all this again?
I don't know. I think we made an alright team.
But all they did was mess up.
We got what we came for, didn't we? Now let's get out of here.
You look really cold. You should take your jacket back.
Nah, don't worry about me. You're smaller. You need all the warmth you can get.
I don't feel right hogging it. It's your jacket, so just take it back already.
If you insist. Alright. Magic the ice away so we can get out of here.
Alright, take this!
Nothing's happening. Quit messing around and break the ice.
What if the wolves are still there?
I don't hear them or see their shadows. We should be fine.
Right. Okay, for real this time.
Something wrong.
I'm just stressed out. So my magic's not working right. Shut up.
So we're trapped in here.
No, we are not trapped. I'm a great witch. It's just a stupid spell doesn't want to happen.
Okay, we're a little bit trapped. Magic is connected to your state of mind, right? Try to calm down.
Calm as frick!
Butterscotch.
Everything's under control. My emotions are completely in check, so my magic's gonna be working just fine.
Butterscotch. What? Talk to me. What's wrong?
Oh, what if I can't get us out of here? Are we gonna die because of me?
No, you're a great witch, remember? We'll make it.
But I can't even get this spell to work. Sealing the cave was just an accident in the first place. I panicked and it just...
Hey, you'll get it. You've got talent. If you can make gumdrop, you can melt ice. Just take a deep breath and try again.
I didn't. I didn't make gumdrop. I don't know who did. I just took the credit to make myself look better. Oh, sorry, you thought wrong. Stupid ice! Stupid wall! Stupid!
Butterscotch? Is your magic still going haywire? Because you look different. What?
My spell came undone. Don't look at me.
Huh?
This body is just an illusion. It's not the real me. That's not very convincing.
This is what she meant.
That wolf girl from before told me you were wasting all your magic with some useless spell.
It's not useless. I need it. I can't let anyone except Toffee see me this way. Please, don't tell anyone.
Why do you hide behind a transformation all the time?
People don't take you seriously when you look like I do. I want to be a beautiful, fearsome witch that everyone admires, but instead I'm...
Your...
Everything about me is fake already, and I'm always lying to everyone. I'm barely any good with magic, and I can't even bear to let anyone see what I really look like. And now I'm gonna die because I'm a big fat coward who can never tell you the truth. Are you... Well, say something. Aren't you gonna yell at me? Don't you hate me?
I don't hate you. I don't hate you at all, Butterscotch. I never have. What are you saying? Sometimes I wonder why we're always fighting. And I guess it's because that's the way we are. But it's not like I ever actually hated you.
You're lying.
Why would I lie? There's no point. We'll both be dead soon enough. Unless we find a way out of here, that is.
But, I mean, I thought you hated anyone who can do magic. You do, don't you?
That's not it. I think that being able to do things without magic takes an incredible understanding of the world and its elements. And that's awesome. So when it feels like no one else sees that, I get frustrated. Maybe I don't trust magic users in general, but still, no. I've never hated you just for being a witch. What? Why are you staring at me like that?
Aren't you gonna at least make fun of me? For looking like this?
Why should anyone care what you look like? It's not their business. You're not hurting anyone, so who cares?
You just don't get it. Everyone thinks you're cool, and you don't even have to try. You don't know what it's like.
Hey, I tried to be taken seriously, too. Everyone sees my alchemy as a gimmick. It's like I'm doing cheap tricks compared to everyone else in town full of magic users.
Well, anyone can make decent candy with magic, but yours tastes the best.
Of course they do. I'm a genius when it comes to candy making.
Jeez, you're so confident.
I have to be. Otherwise, I'd just give up and do something boring with my life instead.
Hey, remember the day we first met? When I came into your store to make fun of how bad your alchemy would make the tasty candy taste? But then you forced me to try a piece?
And you were so impressed that you begged me to teach you how to make them? But I was still mad, so I refused. And you declared us rivals?
Yeah, I remember. I just think maybe if not for our big egos, we could have become friends sooner.
Yeah, maybe.
Thanks, Syrup. I feel a lot better. My magic might work now, so I want to give it another shot.
With her mind at ease, Butterscotch is finally able to focus and melt the wall of ice that had trapped the pair in the cavern. They made their way back down the mountain without incident to an unfrozen and very relieved gumdrop. Eager to get working on the ultimate suite, they promptly returned Butterscotch to her cottage.
Toffee, I'm home! Our mission was a success!
Master? Oh, your spell!
I know, don't worry. It's a long story. I'll tell you later.
You have dog scent on you. Those wolves didn't give you any trouble, did they?
Yeah, I should have went with you. I was just being a scaredy cat.
Oh, Toffee.
Hey, I'm just fine. Calm your whiskers. You were worried about me.
I want to take this mission with your greatest rival. A lot could have gone wrong.
Yeah.
I guess we probably shouldn't say anything about all this reason to death then. Anyway, I shouldn't keep drums operating outside. See ya! Poor Toffee.
Hey, before you go, there's one more thing I should tell you. Promise you won't hate me?
Yeah, I promise.
Okay, I've been using this crystal ball to spy in your lab sometimes. I'm really sorry!
What?
Here, take it. I won't use it anymore. I know it was bad, but I wanted to try to learn how you make candy so I can do it myself. But you're seeing the stick of using it, and I couldn't figure it out at all, so it was all for nothing. I'm really, really sorry.
Thanks for telling me, I guess.
You don't hate me?
I said I wouldn't. I wasn't sure how you'd take it. I thought you'd be a lot madder. Well, we did just get back from near-death experience. The fact that you've been spying on me seems kind of consequential after that. Yeah, but there was this one night recorded in there. I think you'll probably want to see it. What name was that? What happened? Just watch it later when you get the chance. It's important. Okay.
Syrup, are you ready to return home and finish the ultimate sweet?
Yeah, sorry to keep you waiting. Later, butterscotch.
Don't forget to bring me some when it's done. I won't forgive you if I don't get to taste it.
Hey, we're back.
It's late. I was starting to get really worried. I am sorry to have worried you, Master Pestio, but we are working on a top secret surprise, so we will tell you all about our adventure when it is finished.
A surprise? Okay then, I'll hold off asking where you've been all day. We'll be downstairs, so don't come in until we finish working, alright? So the surprise is a special treat. I should have guessed. Just try not to stay up all night. I know how you get when you're working on something big.
I don't need you giving me a bedtime. I'll sleep when it's done. Syrup's enthusiasm for desserts is unmatched. Let us begin our work.
Syrup and Gumdrop retreat to the basement, spending an hour after hour preparing the ultimate sweet. Finally, all that's left is to let it chill overnight.
We did good, Gumdrop. Thanks for all your help.
I'm glad I could be of assistance. I cannot wait for Master Pestil to try it.
Yeah, me too. You stay here and keep an eye on things. I'm gonna go pass out.
Roger that. I will see you in the morning.
Now's a good chance to watch whatever's on this thing. Let's see what Butterscotch wanted to show me.
Kohi! Hello! Fun Kohi!
I knew it was Pestio. They made it pretty obvious it was Pestio from the start.
How are you doing? You said you were going to stream today, buddy. Remember?
I'm like 80-something points away.
How are you doing today? Tonight?
It's Wonchon's birthday. I had to draw. You could have drawn on stream. I'm just saying.
Did you get it done?
I need to go looking for a new post?
No, I get too distracted.
Fair. That's fair, though.
But I just finished. Ooh, did you post it already?
So we're pausing mid-game so I can go see if there's new art.
Yeah, okay.
So we're pausing mid-stream so I can go see if there's new art. We knew that it was going to end up being Pestio from the start, so here we go. I'll go look at it on Instagram later.
Oh, that's cute. I love how that came out. That looks so good. Happy birthday!
That's cute. Okay, anyway.
Congrats on getting it finished.
Happy birthday, baby girl. Does Wonchon count as a baby girl? Look, I'm not privy to the baby girl conversations, really, but, like... Does he count as a baby girl? Oh, absolutely. Does he? Because I would have called him a baby boy, but baby girl? He's a shitty bro. Exactly, I would call him baby girl. Or, no, you're right. Or, baby boy, but, like, baby girl. Isn't baby girl more like the older... Well, typically they seem to be, like, older and stuff. I don't know, maybe it's just people I talk to. Who's also kind of obsessed with, like, Call of Duty and stuff, so... Maybe that's just where I'm getting all my secondhand information. Like, I'd call him baby boy. He's absolutely a brat. But... Okay, so baby girl is a way of life, and that's what Wonchon chose.
Ah, I see.
Fair enough. Look, I legitimately, like, for the most part, what was it? Like, one of them did, like, a bingo for it. I think a couple of them did the bingo for it. I'd have to search this chat. I'm not in the mood to search this group chat for it, but, like, they tend to stick with, like, the older men who are kind of grizzly and but have, like, the soft spot, I guess, or blah, blah, I don't know, whatever. It's fine. Everything's fine.
So anyway, we're about to see if Syrup's going to be feel betrayed by Pastille being the creator of Gumdrop, even though he kind of didn't hide it very well. Like, she should have realized it a while ago.
That should be it. Did it work? Are you alive now? Maybe I messed up the spell.
Hello, Master. What is your command?
Oh, you're working. I did it!
Please issue a command.
Right. I didn't think this through. What's the best way to explain? Okay, I have this friend. She's not very sociable and has kind of a thing against magic, so it's really hard for her to make friends here.
Please issue a command.
Yes, sorry. I guess what I'm asking is if maybe you could try, even though you're made from magic and you're also candy, so it should be okay, I think.
Unable to process. Please state your command clearly.
I really should have thought this through better. Please try to get along with my friend Syrup.
Unable to process. Please provide instructions on how to get along.
Well, first of all, the way you talk is really unnatural. You're speaking more casually. You know, be friendly.
How is this?
Better. Keep talking.
I still do not understand what you want me to do, Master. It sounds too complicated.
I'm sorry. I know golems aren't usually used for things like this, but I didn't have much of a choice. My friend hates talking to magic users.
Speaking of which, she absolutely cannot know that I made you. She still thinks I'm just like her and can't use magic.
Okay, I will work hard.
Right, now I think you're doing great. Just keep acting like a regular person and you'll be friends with her in no time.
Acting like...
Yeah, even though you're made out of candy, it feels like I'm talking to a real human. Just keep being yourself.
Being myself?
Yep, consider that to be your main objective.
Hopefully it's simple enough.
Act human, but I am candy.
Be myself. Act like a person. I am candy, but act...
Whoops, maybe it was too complicated.
I did... I didn't even click. He just straight up broke her.
Stop!
Did I break you?
Looks like I messed it up again.
This one seemed so promising. I probably have better luck getting Sai to talk to other magic users than getting a golem to work right. It's a lot to go to waste, though. I guess I'll take it apart and... But this is the only one that talked to me. She was sentient.
I give up now. Would it be like I killed you?
I won't give up on you. I won't give up on Syrup either. You're going to be friends somehow, I swear it.
The Pastille actually turned out to be a witch.
Damn it, what am I supposed to do with this information? Why would he make me a fake friend? Why would he hide all his talent and waste his time working here? Who am I even supposed to talk to about all this?
I should just go return this thing.
What do you know? It's the candy alchemist, meow! What are you doing here at this hour?
Is Butterscotch awake? I came to give this back.
Master is fast asleep. Were you hoping you could talk to her, meow?
No, I figured she'd be asleep, so...
But you still came all the way in the middle of the night.
Not like I'd be able to fall asleep anyway. Well, here's your crystal ball. I'll be back tomorrow with the ultimate suite.
Leaving so soon? I thought we could have a little chat while you're here, meow.
Alright, Kat. What do you want to talk about, then?
There's plenty to say. For instance, do you know Master Secret, Niao? She works pretty hard to keep up appearances, so that's kind of a big deal, Niao.
Yeah, I guess. Why do you think people hide things that are such a big part of themselves?
Master does it because she cares a lot about what other people think of her.
Especially when it's the opinion of someone she cares about, right?
Precisely. She's really sensitive, so when someone doesn't like her, she goes out of her way to prove how great she is. It's annoying, because she's already perfectly fine to begin with. The way I see it, if someone doesn't like you, you just have to let them be that way. But as long as she disagrees, she'll keep overcompensating and hiding behind that spell. I think what you said might have helped her a lot, though, so thanks, Nia.
I didn't do much.
Still, if she's more confident now, it means I can relax. I won't have to knock her enemies down a peg to protect her feelings all the time.
How long has she been like this?
It's before I became her familiar. She's always been putting on a front, but you don't have to look very hard to see she's a complete wreck. At first I followed her because I thought it'd be entertaining to watch someone like that. But somehow I became her guardian instead.
Hmm.
What? You got something to say about it?
I was just thinking it's funny you stopped saying meow for once.
Meow! I can't drop this chick for a serious conversation. This is the last time I opened up to you, meow.
Sorry. I do feel a little better after talking to you, though, so thanks, Toffee.
No problem. Yeah, go get some rest. It's really late. Yeah. Feeling a little more at ease after the little chat, Syrup returns home as exhaustion finally hits her. Tomorrow's the day they can actually taste the ultimate sweet.
Me making the mistake of picking a special level card.
I feel like visual novels would be more fun to, like, this is one of those, hey, is somebody around? Do you want to hop on PC and read some characters so I don't have to do 7 different voices? I'm not very good at it.
What just went off?
What is it? I wish it this time. One of these days I want to remember to mute my phone before I start. Today was obviously not that day, but one of these days.
I haven't done my check-in on Genshin. Okay.
I do my check-in later.
You're doing fine, yeah.
I'm doing my best, yeah.
Oh, how is it?
Part of me wants to try talking like that for a whole stream. The other part of me knows I couldn't last more than a minute.
Like, yeah, I could totally, like, do the peppy flips, yeah? But trying to come up with so many puns would drive me insane, you know? I might be able to sneak a couple in here and there, but you know how hard it would be to do that all the time? No, thank you. So, how is it?
It's the best thing I've ever tasted. Whoever came up with this recipe wasn't kidding about the ultimate part.
I completely agree. I feel sort of bad that Gumdrop doesn't have any taste buds to experience this with.
I am just happy to see the two of you enjoying it.
I'm happy too. I thought you forgot about your promise to make this for me, Sai.
Thank you.
Don't start getting all sappy over nothing. Gumdrop's the one who reminded me.
Serving Master Pastille is of the utmost importance.
Shh, don't say things like that. You don't have to be so nice to me.
He's right. If we're too soft on him, we'll stop working so hard. Unacceptable. Anyway, I promised Butterscotch I'd give her a taste of this stuff, so I'm heading out now.
How generous of you. I'm sure she'll love it.
Hey, I brought some of the ultimate sweet like I promised.
You're finally here! Gimme.
So, is it great or what?
It's incredible! It's so cold, but it melts my mouth! I never tasted anything so divine! Not by every batch you make!
Not bad at all. Well done, Candy Alchemist.
I'm just glad it turned out to be worth the effort.
Are you kidding me? You died 1,000 times for one bite of this! It's that good! But anyway, you wanted to talk to me? Does this mean you watched the thing?
Yep.
I'm still trying to figure out what to say to him, but I wanted to thank you for showing me the truth. You're a good friend.
It's not... Wait, we're friends?
Yeah, why not?
Meow! We Sally! Does that mean we get free candy?
Is that all you want out of me?
No, I've just never had a friend that wasn't my pet.
Oh, honey. Butterscotch.
Coffee, was your only friend before now?
I guess we're more alike than I thought.
Except my only friend kind of betrayed my trust.
Syrup, I'm sorry.
Peeking in to say hi, hey, Mizu.
So what if you lied about being able to do magic? Lester lies to me all the time. The only difference is I know all her secrets.
Yeah.
Toffee!
Maybe I'm getting too worked up over it.
It's not like he did anything out.
Bleh. It's not like anything he did was out of malice.
Yeah, he'll probably just keep it secret because he doesn't know how to tell you, since you don't like magic so much.
Oh, snack time. I've actually got pretzel sticks. Or, wait, I've also got... Ooh, yeah, the Rice Krispies would actually probably taste better right now. My niche makes mush crispy treats, sailor die. I snatched someone. I put him in a little biggie. Nya. Nya. Thank you. One of these days I'll get tits to work again. I kind of gave up on it for a bit. Okay, anyway. Yeah, he probably just kept it a secret because he didn't know how to tell you, since you don't like magic so much. You know, actually, lately I've started thinking it's not so bad. But my alchemy is still way better. That ultimate sweet you made was proof enough for mania. So what are you going to do now? You haven't talked to him yet, have you? I will at some point. You shouldn't keep hiding it because of me. I just thought it was more important to come here and share the ultimate sweet with you two first, that's all. You've changed, yeah. What happened up on that mountain to make you so kind? Oh, you know, kind of a lot. What did you do, Master? And so, Syrup taught Butterscotch her alchemical process. The witch invented her own special candy, which she famously named after herself. Butterscotch candies became immediately popular. She was able to sell them not just at Altier Sweets, but in candy stores around the world. Syrup began spending a lot of time at Butterscotch's cabinet. Bastille and Gumdrop didn't mind. They were just glad she finally seemed happy. Butterscotch end. Oh! Well, that was cute. I guess you end with different people as you go? Okay, so does that mean we can get everyone on the screen? Can we get Treat? I want to get Treat. How do I get the wolf girl? And she's super delicious. Don't hold back. I love the flavor text at the bottom. Okay. So, that took about an hour 20. Do we want to go for another ending? I'm also half tempted to switch over to Genshin just because I kept making the jokes. And I know Wintry's in soon. God, I don't want it. I got my primos. I just keep putting off everything else.
I don't wanna.
Okay, so if I click this one, will it just skip to the new text dialogue and then give me an option to go from there? Oh, there's a lot more endings than I thought. Wait a second. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, there's a lot more innings than I thought. Okay. Syrup teaches Butterscotch how to make candy, and it's oh so sweet. Yeah, that bit with Butterscotch was cute, though. Okay. Wait, if I eat Gumdrop right from the start, does that count as an ending? Hang on, I want to see if I can just eat her and get it over with. I know Syrup's really against it, though, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to. Altier Sweets, a candy alchemist, firm believer in science, proud and stubborn, but a magical surprise. What's this thing? Or if I just get rid of her two, or give her two butterscotch? Good morning, how are you today?
Fine.
I am also fine. Just so.
In that case,
I already did do not eat the cute candy girl. In that case. Even if you're human-shaped and alive, you look pretty delicious. Eat the candy.
Let's go.
Did you need me for something, Sai? No, I changed my mind. Go back upstairs. Oh, we have a guest. Made of candy? I'm not sharing, so don't even ask.
Okay. I'll just get back to work then.
Good. All right, candy girl. Time to see what you're made of. Your insights are pretty realistic. Wait a second. No, it doesn't seem like your organs are actually functional. You're 100% magic powered, aren't you?
I'm sorry? Are you dissecting her? I'm sorry?
Um.
I do not know the details of my biology. It doesn't hurt when I pull things out like...
I'm sorry? Syrup, what the fuck is going on?
No, I was not designed to feel pain.
Do you know where the parts of your body came from? Because most of the candy looks like mine, except covered in gross magic.
Hey, who made you anyway? That is a secret.
Sorry to intrude, I brought you two some drinks.
Candy biopsy. Trying to figure out which part do I want to eat.
I'm so sorry, buddy.
She told me to. So if I told you to eat me, would you? That's different.
Eat her anyway.
Listen, Pastille. I've got this walking amalgamation of deliciousness all laid out, literally asking me to eat it. So I'm going to eat it. It doesn't matter what she's made of. I can't believe you just eat a person. Don't you have a heart?
You want me to answer that?
I can't. I don't think I can deal with this. It's too much.
You've already decided on this, haven't you?
Fine. I don't want to believe it, but you turned out to be the lost cause after all. Do whatever you want. I'm leaving.
Oh.
It really does take a while to eat a person's body weight and candy, huh?
But all of you taste so good. That sounds so fucking creepy. That sounds so creepy. Wait a second.
I should try to make another review myself. Without magic, of course. I wonder if I could do it. Imagine how much I could sell something like that for, too.
Syrup, are we friends?
Huh? What do you care? You're just candy.
Oh, I see.
Speaking of friends, where the heck is Pastille? Some of his stuff is missing and he hasn't come in since a couple of days ago now? I can't believe he's throwing such a huge fit over this. That kid is so fired.
Syrup continued to eat the candy girl until she was no more. After countless attempts to create another, she was forced to give up when her store was closed down due to declining sales. Pastille never returned.
Candy will end.
Yeah, I thought that was gonna... Yep.
Yep.
So if I do that again, and then we just skip to the part where we can change our mind, what does Pastille do?
Candy ball.
Okay, I see your point.
I get it, you're right. Even if she's made of candy, she's still a person. I won't eat her. So glad you understand.
No! Master Pastille, why did you prevent me from fulfilling my destiny as candy?
Master?
I don't know what that's about.
Please just call me Pastille.
Anyway, let's get you closed up so Syrup can get back to her work. Let's get into the makeup today, right?
I wouldn't have to if we just harvest her organs.
That is not an option!
Look, I'm being nice enough to not eat her, but you know it's obvious where she came from, right? What are you talking about?
It was that rotten witch! I forgot to lock up the place last night and she left the golem to spy on us or something.
That's one theory, I suppose.
I mean, she's really suspicious, right? Hey, candy girl, what are you here for?
My main objective is to get along with Syrup.
See, she's definitely a spy. Since I can't eat her, I want her out of here.
Sure, no problem. Come with me, Miss Candy Spy.
Oh, I have been given a name.
No, it was just...
Whatever, let's go.
One more batch of these, and shoot. Guess I'm taking a shopping break. Okay, so then every day after cleaning stone, we take inventory.
Writing a story sounds like a lot of work. I have a newfound respect for you, Master Pastille.
What is this? What are you doing?
Oh, I'm teaching her to run the store. I am helping.
No. You're supposed to make her leave.
Why did you dress her up like that?
Would you rather she kept walking around naked? She needs a uniform. She's going to work here.
She's not working here.
I want to work for Syrup. Let's get along.
Cut it out.
What are you thinking?
Okay, so I saw all this earlier. We're gonna take her to Butterscotch, and then we're gonna give her to Butterscotch, because I didn't do that earlier.
I already told you, she's not staying with us. They made her, they can have her.
Wait, you really brought it to give it to me?
Just take your candy weirdo back and leave me alone.
Huh? Come on, Pastille.
Are we leaving?
Sorry, you have to stay here.
But how will I get along with Syrup?
I promise to visit you soon. I'm sorry.
Sweet, free candy servant.
I like you for asking ya.
The next day, Pastel checks in on the candy girl. Butterscotch has been diligently eating her away, leaving the poor girl in a miserable state. Very concerned, Pastel confronts Syrup about the consequences of her actions.
We can't let Butterscotch keep treating her so badly. Some of her limbs are missing. She looks so sad.
Not my problem.
Please, Syrup. I know you love shutting people out, but I'm really worried about her. Butterscotch won't listen to me. I need your help.
We're gonna ignore him to start.
No, I don't feel like it. Why don't you understand?
This whole thing was just a waste of time.
Bestial didn't return.
Syrup spent a sleepless night at the front of the desk waiting for him to show up with the candy girl in tow to give her an evil for being so irresponsible.
I'm outside right now, but NomnomNami is my jam. Why didn't you tell me? Hello? I mentioned bed in theater yesterday. I'm sorry.
This was unplanned. I have played all their games and even bought this Spice comic. Ooh, I was eyeballing that earlier, actually.
I don't know. Wait, I am so for this creator. Please help. The art is so cute.
Yeah, after playing Bad in Theater was so good. Bad in Theater was so good. I'm half tempted to go back and play. I've got all the endings, and I still kind of want to play it again. But it is so, it's so cute. I need to get through. There's like 10 endings on this one. Have you gotten all the endings? They're the reason I got into making Frimpy games like a few years ago.
Ooh!
Mario game one!
At that moment, every game, there was no time to dwell on it either. She had a store to run.
Why isn't anyone coming in?
Yes, I got all the endings. I forgot how to get them though.
Ah. Yeah, like I said, yesterday I did Bad in Theater and got all 41 endings. And then proceeded to get the true ending. And then the true ending.
It was really, like, Bad in Theater was really good though. Oh, I forgot to flip the open sign.
I was streaming it to BF. He got me into the games and he was the one helping me with the endings.
Ah! Yeah, I'm gonna probably end up looking up how to get some of these, because at least with Bad in Theater, I guess you like literally gives you a chart to help you figure out what you need to do to get on.
Yeah, it's the cat. I see business have been slow for you today, Nya.
Wanna buy some candy?
No, maybe some other time.
And why are you here?
Master is wondering what you're up to, Nya.
My assistant bailed on me, so I'm stuck doing everything he used to do.
What a coincidence! We recently had a servant disappear as well. Perhaps they ran away together.
Figures.
Yeah.
Want to make a random game? It must be about my children.
Ooh!
God, I miss Syrup so much. She's great. I hardly remember how to get all the endings. I need to go back and play the treat series after watching that in theater.
Yeah, like I said, I pulled up a list of like the recommended, quote unquote, recommended way to play them. And this was the first one on the list. Technically, Bad in Theater's last, but you know, whatever. Too late.
Why did you add Nya to your senses?
Well, let's be honest, Kohee. You don't think it would get very annoying to have to listen to me go Nya every time you speak? And I don't think I can sit there and come up with that many puns. I'm not that good.
Oh, no. Dating Sim, but it's Mario's children. Treat series is such a treat.
Do it, do it, do it. Mario, please, I'm begging, please.
Never.
I think I would drive myself insane first, Nya. Like, I can only go through this so much, Nya. Like, I don't know what you want from me. You know this is... It's a very difficult gimmick to keep up, I believe. Even Tall feature hops it for serious conversations, Nya.
Yeah, they've been updated in the anthology, just in chapter 8. Ooh!
passes Kenneth under the table. You know what you need to do.
Oh, I see how it is, Kohi. Okay. We can come to an arrangement, I'm sure.
Let's do a whole stream with just that voice. I need to do something voiced so that I didn't have to sit here and read everything.
I wonder if I could keep that up for a whole stream, yeah? You know, trying to come up. I don't think I'd be very good with the puns, but you never know.
It's necessary you do it.
Well, here. We could try a whole stream to swap being like this now. I wonder how well it would go.
I don't wanna cry.
I'm so sorry, Kohi. I can't make Mario cry. My parent can't cry.
Sounds like we have our next channel point idea. Entire Nyastri. Bruh, I still need to figure out how to do the karaoke one. And it's like, doing it because I can't do it during the day when the kid's here, but I can't do it at night because I have neighbors. So it's like, ah.
Oh no. Oh no, I think we broke Maru. No, Maru!
Looks like you could use some help, yeah? I'm fine running this place on my own.
Oh, so we were closed all morning on purpose?
Shut up!
Why don't you hire me? You can just pay me a candy. I don't mind, yeah?
Hire the cats. Fine, but I'm making you wear the uniform. You want the pants or the skirt?
Neither, yeah. I like my own clothes just fine.
This is literally the only condition of the handling the storefront. I'm not hiring you if you won't wear it.
Are you sure? You look like you really need employees, yeah.
Damn cat. Do whatever you want.
Coffee begins running the storefront, improving sales and I'm at the cafe. Hey, it's Chris trying to do an art project together, and I want to make that darn game. My hands are full with commissions too.
No!
Oh no, Maru!
Maru, do I need to throw more money at you? Coffee begins running the storefront, immediately improving sales. Syrup keeps herself locked in the basement, suddenly producing more and more candy, trying to keep up with the town's sweet tooth. In as little as a week, her shop has completely transformed into a place she no longer recognized. Hey, is it just me, or did the vibe up here totally change?
I'm only responding to the customer's needs, Nia. Speaking of which, the focus group testing has shown that we need to get on the magical candy market.
What? Absolutely not. The whole point of the store is none of the candy is made with magic.
Esther's already agreed to help, so you don't have to worry about that part. Just let her take care of it, Nia.
You're taking over my store?
Oh, you finally caught on. And I'll tell you this, too. The whole reason we've been doing so well is because of magic, Nia.
Throw money at Maru? Yes, throw money at Maru. Let's go, Kadris. Let's go. There you go. Just in case you needed it. What do you mean?
Master has been jinxing everyone to crave your sweets. The more money we make, the more candy she gets.
That's just messed up.
Anything for Master. If you don't like it, feel free to quit, Nya. You won't be entitled to any of the profits anymore, though.
I don't want any for stealing money. I'm leaving.
Suit yourself, Nya.
Why'd Pastel have to abandon me like this? That traitor. Let me make that lumps clear. Syrup left town in search of a place far removed from magic. She was forced to spend the rest of her days in obscurity, never staying in one place very long. This ensured no one could get close enough to betray her again. Bad end 2. What is bad end 1? Wait. You ate her. I can't believe you actually ate her.
Oh no! Oh
no! Feed Butterscotch took over Altia's sweets. If I do that again and don't hire the cat, is it
a different ending?
Let's find out, yeah?
Okay, so we're gonna send her over there. I'm not that desperate. No way. No more new hires. This is my store and I'll manage just fine.
Oh well, in that case, I wish you the best of luck. See you around, you.
But running the store on our own proved to be more of a challenge than Syrup expected. Her unpleasant demeanor kept customers at bay, and the less candies sold, the more frustrated she felt. It wasn't long before Altair Sweets was forced to close down, and Syrup was left with nothing and no one. That end one.
Okay, so we got the first bad end and the second bad end. Does this make for a bad end three? Oh, and there's an ending between the cannibal ending and... Oh, there's so many endings I haven't seen yet.
It's less than Bad End Theater, but at least, like I said, Bad End Theater at least gave you the option of seeing a map so you can figure out what you needed to do.
This one. Printing text after choices transition.
I came in late. Have you already eaten the girl? Yes. That was the second thing I did. The first one, I actually went through the game properly, and I got the butterscotch ending, which was cute. But the second one I did was I eated her. Syrup teaches butterscotch how to make candy, and it's oh so sweet. But yeah, candy bowl ending. You ate her. I can't believe you actually ate her.
It's like, no.
Oh no!
Are there any other endings that are super fast, like easy to get? A candy bowl ending was the first ending I got. It might be have called me a syrup kid.
Oh no! How could you, Maru?
I actually can't believe you'd eat gumdrop like that.
What did she do? She was nothing but cute and just wanted to get along with Syrup. Oh no. How could you?
I like sweets. Yeah, the first ending I got was the butterscotch ending. Can you get an ending with Treat though? Because if Treat has like a whole little mini series otherwise. I was also an edgy bitch at the time.
Yeah.
I'm literally eating a candy cane right now, but I'd never do that to poor gumdrop.
I mean, your candy cane isn't talking to you, right? So, I think it's okay.
Okay, so yeah, lonely wolf treat. That one looks like it's gonna be cute as hell too. We're just gonna have to do like a week of just me playing these games. Except for tomorrow, because tomorrow's Amori. Okay, so my greatest joy in this world is the fact that I've got other people playing Amori now. Like, literally on Twitter, on Twitter, Grey Cat Cafe. Do you remember Grey, Maru? Because I know she got a redesign from you. But she legitimately tagged me saying, you know, then Amori for the first time, and then tagged me saying that me and others playing it has convinced her to try it. Yes, I know. Yeah, so she's trying Amori on Wednesday. And then one of, I don't know if Axel's here or not, but one of Mari's mods, Axel, because I chat with him every once in a while, and he's like, yeah, I was thinking about it recently, and I think I've almost gotten completely talked into getting a commission from you to get like the little Amori sprite so that he can try it. And it's like, yeah, my greatest joy in life is getting other people to play Amori right now. Especially since I'm still working on the Hikikomori route. It's like, I absolutely see how this was, you know, 25% of my Steam. And it'd be a hell of a lot more if I wasn't playing the Hikikomori route on Switch.
I love this game. God, it's so good. It has definitely left its mark on me. But anyway.
Oh, don't owe me. Ooh, well, I'm gonna Cray Wood. I'm gonna message Cray here in a minute.
So, note to self.
I don't really have any interest in playing Amori myself, but the art style is cute and Mario does his portraits. It's really, okay, look, it's really dark, but it is actually really, really good. Like, I've really enjoyed it. So, obviously. Obviously. Okay, let's see, what other endings can we get? We're not eating the candy girl. We already tried eating her. All right, we'll keep her. Fine, she can work for one day, but after that, I want her out.
Thank you, Syrup. I will not disappoint you.
The slow pace in the beginning is not for me, but I thoroughly enjoy watching Saywix play.
Yeah.
Like I said, I really like it. I don't know. It's the story got me a lot more than I was expecting it to. For the record, Salix, I was looking at Mori stuff on Etsy, but decided on the other stuff.
Okay, so speaking of Mori stuff, I haven't tried super hard either, because it's like, if somebody wants to own up to it, they'll come to me and go, hey, did you get a thing? But,
I got this, like, basil shaker charm, and then there was this really, really cute pin that's like a little cat on some books. And I don't know where it came from, but, you know, get this little... one of those bubble charms. It's adorable. Don't know where it came from, but adorable.
I will not disappoint you.
She's already started taking inventory by herself? What a hard worker. What are you smiling about? She'll steal your job at this rate.
Ah! Slow down!
Well, I guess that's settled. I need to do some shopping.
Wait! You waited. Thank you.
Yeah, what do you want?
Master Pastille told me he will handle the inventory taking. If you are running errands, I would like to help.
There was a beanie with sprout moles on it that was pretty cute.
Ooh.
It does get cold here sometimes. Right now, it's been like really warm the last like week. But... like, it's legitimately almost 60 now. It has been warm this past week, but it gets cold. Like, I think it's supposed to drop again this week.
And this is how we get sick, folks, because the temperature keeps changing, yeah? And you know how your body doesn't adjust to it necessarily? Especially when you've got allergies and your body's sensitive to that anyway, yeah? So I'm definitely going to have a sinus headache later this week, yeah?
Well, it can't be as bad as, like, right before Christmas, though. Right before Christmas when it legitimately was, like, a negative 25 wind chill.
Whew.
But yeah, it's been warm recently. Whatever floats your boat.
Fine, let's go.
Asa!
Oh, speaking of Omori... so apparently the basil plush is supposed to be coming back in stock soon. Speaking of beanies, I don't think you ever answered my question if you weren't the one.
Yes. yes.
Indeedy. I thought it was cute.
Yeah.
Like I said, I don't think there's anything else. I did send something to Mario a while ago, but I don't know that it said it was delivered, so I don't know. But otherwise, nothing else that I sent out should be out. I've got something for Lumi, but I still need another piece of it, so I can't send that until Q sends me stuff. This Q got part of the thing that I need. Anyway.
So, what are we shopping for today, Syrup?
Tartrazine.
I have never heard of that. Does it make your candy tastier?
It's food coloring. It doesn't taste like anything.
Oh, I was hoping we might find something to
buy something to make me taste better. And we're back on the, hey, eat me, eat me, eat me, eat me.
Yeah.
Why? So I want to eat you?
Yes.
Well, you're out of luck. No matter what you taste like, I'm not eating you.
Syrup, you are a very stubborn person.
Yep.
Oh, here we go. A trial scene. Mission complete. Now you can make more inventory for me to take.
Sure. Just don't forget you're only staying for one day. I'm gonna use something in my mind.
Ah. That is fine with me. I will just have to become your friend before then. Oh, it's a candy acronymous, meow. Syrup, a kitty cat. Yeah, wow, where'd you get such an impressive golem? I thought you hated magic things, meow.
What do you want?
You whiskers. I'm not so rude as to decline greeting my master's rival when I see her. Salutations, meow. Oh, how polite. It is nice to meet you, kitty. My name's Toffin, yeah. And what do they call you, Miss Golem? I have not yet been given a name. Oh, yo-ho! How sad for you! But really, Candy Alchemist, I'm very surprised to see this new friend of yours. Oh, I did not think we had become friends yet, but I am working very hard at it.
She doesn't look familiar to you? After all, it was your master who made her, right?
Was it? I had no idea.
You aren't fooling anyone, Cat. That rotten witch is the only one who tried to prank me like this. She made this golem to either spy on me or try to sabotage my business somehow.
Sabotage your business? Mastership as a customer, yeah? That doesn't make a lick of sense. I'm sure if she were here, she tried to take responsibility for it, though. It takes some high-level magic to do things like that, yeah? Which brings us back to my first point. Why is the Candy Alchemist, who's so outspokenly anti-magic, strolling around with such an unscientific creature, yeah?
I'll admit, you do have a point, Cat. I'm trying so hard not to go back. I go back to Genshin way too often. I was about to say, well, if you look at Albedo, he's technically... Take her home. God. No, I'm... I can't. I could. Leave without her. Which one's gonna get me an ending faster? Toffee really is like... I love Toffee. I love Toffee. Toffee is fantastic.
Take her home.
Come on, we're getting out of here.
Okay, goodbye, Toffee. Running away, yeah? Well, thanks for the interesting chat.
I love Toffee.
The pair made their way home, and Syrup went straight back to work, making more delicious candies. In appreciation for the candy girl's enthusiasm and general willingness to be helpful, the candy alchemist decided to keep her as an assistant. And so, the golem started living with Syrup and Pastille at the Altio Suites. She became a mascot figure for the shop, boosting sales instantly. She's adorable, to be fair, so, like...
Gel, jelly, something... no.
Don't think of something. I have faith in you, Syrup. Okay, here, we're naming Gumdrop. We'll go through those instead of skipping. What's going on over here?
I'm trying to come up with a name for her.
You're naming her? What happened to candy golems aren't pets?
Well, I can't just keep calling her candy weirdo.
Technically, you could.
No, we really should give you a proper name.
How about Gumdrop? Gumdrop! It's a nice name.
I think she likes it.
Yes, I knew if it was Syrup, she would pick something good.
Okay, we're not doing those two again. I can't. Not for sale. Why are you gasping, though? What's up, Maru? What's up? Not for sale. You can buy any other candy in here, but this one's mine.
Syrup, I'm delighted that you think of me as yours.
Don't take it the wrong way. You just work for me. Your looks are good for business.
What a shame. Golems are said to be such excellent servants. We've come to want one of our own. Hello, hello. This game looks very cute. And so, thank you. Hey.
Yeah, I this whole artist, like all of her games, look so freaking cute. I played Bad in Theater yesterday, and it's like, okay, I want to play more games from her.
I really, really like the pixely look of Bad End Theater, but I love how, like, just how cute these are, too. They're great. But hello!
You could just... Okay, back to me. Ooh, I gotta check them out. They're called NomnomNami. And so much pink.
Great. Like I said, if you look up Bad End Theater, it comes right up.
Bad End Theater is so good.
But then... Here's... This is actually the... I found this. So this is the order that I decided I'm going to play them in. Except for Bad End Theater, because I did that yesterday. Excuse me. How are you today? I'm doing pretty good. I fell asleep and ended up taking like a 3-hour nap, but like otherwise, I'm pretty good. I can yeah. How are you doing today? I hope your New Year started off well. It sounds so nice. Yeah, last night I was having a bit of insomnia, so I couldn't fall asleep. So I know I was awake at like 6:30. And then back awake by like 10:30 or something like that. So I ended up just like passing out for a few hours. But good, had Korean barbecue and finished building my gears. Ooh! That's not a bad way to spend the day. Sounds like a... Oh man, I hope you're not too sleepy anymore. Yee! If nothing else, I'll take some like melatonin or something tonight and try to get on a sleep schedule. I don't believe that's gonna happen, but I can try. I can pretend. It's fine. The real mistake was deciding to do a second visual novel. Good, I believe. Yee. But yee. I'm glad that you decided to stop and say hello. You're just in time to watch me be really bad at voice acting. I've got one register. So this hasn't been going the best. But I've been trying my best, yeah? You know, you just have to, you gotta do your best, you know? You can do magic. Make one yourselves. Oh, no, no. It is a very high-level spell that requires focused passion. Even our combined power couldn't result in anything close to that. I'm sure you can get it if you tried. Not that I know anything about magic. Whoa. We'll just have to give it a go sometime then, No, I suppose we should purchase something sweet and be on our way. What the voice? Yeah, that's, there's a cat person in this game, and it's been a magical experience. Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of the voice that I've given Toffee, and, apparently we've come to the conclusion that I need to try to,
you know, fit more nyas into my speech somehow. I don't know how I'm gonna do it, because I'm not very good with puns, but you never know. It's been a very magical experience.
Oh, he tried to bribe me with catnip earlier, so. Parmesan's lovely, doesn't it, brother?
We have that. Allow me to assist you at the register.
She's so friendly, isn't she? I think she ever does. Okay, let's see. I supervised earlier. Working with him? Yeah, let's work with him. Lending you a hand running the storefront, maybe? Very funny. No joke, dude. You actually help with all the work you usually push off onto me because you hate doing it? Is there something you want?
Just to spend some time with my bestest buddy, Pastille.
Come on, isn't that weird for me to take a break from candy making to help with the candy shopkeeping? Honestly, yes. Yes, it is. What do you want from me? Well, maybe I just want a little change of pace. Is it okay if I work with you for one afternoon? Your people skills are lacking. You never remember where any of the inventory goes, and whenever you clean anything, I always have to go over it a second time. And make me better at all those things. I already made up my mind, so no more whining about what an awful job I do.
You exist, if you insist.
5 minutes later. No, I told you not to put the gumballs next to the jawbreakers. A little kid might hurt themselves. Oh, it's their fault for being an idiot kid.
This is why we keep you in the basement.
You're a danger to society. Isn't she technically his boss? Wait.
Little did you know, I've been poisoning the candy all along. I'm a danger no matter where you put me. Please don't joke about that. It's gonna haunt me with every sale we make. Yeah, since I'm already screwing up your precious shelves, got anything for me to clean instead? Thanks to Gumdrop to help, everything's extra clean already. I thought I'd make a list of candies we're running a little low on, and you could just go back downstairs to... Stop, I get it. Let me finish this job the way you want me to, at least, and I'll be out of your hair. You actually put everything where it should go. I've never been more proud of you than in this moment, so... See, I can be helpful when I put my mind to it. So, glad you're in charge of all these things instead of me, though. Let's just say the store would be in deep trouble if we traded jobs. I don't know the first thing about candy making candy. Speaking of candy, I wanted to thank you. What for? Even though you have your issues with anything and everything magical, you're still letting Gumdrop work for us. I know you didn't like it at first, but now you're letting her stay here. So, thanks. I don't know. You're making it sound like I approve of her now. So, you'd still rather she wasn't around? In case she's trying to hurt my business, yes, I'd rather not endanger our store. If she's not, then sorry, I was wrong. Can you really blame me for being suspicious, though? No, of course not. I'm just glad to see that despite everything, you're finally letting someone new into your life. More accurately, she busted in out of nowhere like a giant sugary pest. I didn't think I'd ever be annoyed by candy, but here we are. Oh, don't say that. She's a golem. That means all she can do is follow orders from her creator. And what do you think those orders were? She hasn't stolen it from us yet. She could just be trying to gain her trust before the lethal strike. Spending all your time worrying about how someone's going to betray you isn't a very good way to live your life. True, but I'm keeping my guard up for now. There's no way to make friends. I'm not looking to make any friends. I already got you. Isn't that enough? Side, to be honest, I'm tired of watching you scare everyone off with your attitude. I know you're sensitive. I'm not sensitive. You're sensitive. This is exactly what I'm talking about. Are you hungry? I'm kind of hungry. I'm gonna go bring back some lunch. See ya. And she ran away. She always does. Oh, she suddenly came out. Toffee, what do we do? Butterscotch. Cat. What are you doing creepily lurking outside my store? It really hurts my feelings when you don't remember my name, yeah? Don't dodge the question, and don't try to run away! Hey, this is a public road! We're well within our rights to loiter here. We can see your golem, yeah? Toffee told me she's doing quite well in your hands. You know, the golem that I so magnificently created. Yep, your little spy is a pretty diligent worker. Makes it worth keeping her around. I was just here to check on her. That's right. See for myself how diligent she is being at, spying up close. Deflection and avoidance, best way to deal with problems. I mean, honestly, I can't say much, but like... Unless you're gonna buy something, I don't want you in my store. I bought some dosh. I can buy your candy if you mean... I brought some dosh. I can buy your candy if it means I can check out your... my golem. Whatever, as long as you two behave yourselves. Oh, it's just a kitty cat from before. Who is your friend? This is my master, the great and powerful witch Butterscotch. Be grateful she's going gracing you with her presence. Yeah. Oh, there she is. Such beautiful gummy skin. Oh, if I could just try a bite of that hair. You haven't already? That's odd, considering you claim that you made her. That's because I had to send her over in flawless condition. I shot a letter straight, you know, but it paid off. She's perfect. Yeah, Master's at her limit. Should let her have a taste before she loses it, yeah? Absolutely not. You can have any other candy in here except for Crumb Drop. How cruel! You just want to keep her all for yourself, don't you? I'll put up with it for now. Just don't forget that golem actually belongs to me. Yeah, enough whining. Just buy something and get out. Don't get any of your gross magic or drool on my stock. My magic isn't gross. You should take this drool as a compliment. Yeah. Come on, Toffee. Let's blow this popsicle stand. The next time those two come by, we should really just pretend we're closed. Syrup, do you dislike Miss Butterscotch? She's a witch. You dislike witches? Some more than others.
Butterscotch is the worst, though. She thinks my alchemy has nothing on her magic, which is totally wrong, of course.
Then why does she buy so much of your candy?
Because no matter how hard she tries, her magical candies never taste as good as mine. She probably thinks if she eats enough, she'll be able to absorb the knowledge.
If she really thought her magic was better, I do not think she would support you by buying so many of your candies. You should be nicer to her.
Whether or not she means what she says, it's her attitude that drives me up the wall. I'm just not capable of being nice to someone like that. What do you care, anyway?
I would like for Syrup to get along with everyone.
Is that what your creator wants, too? For me to be friends with Butterscotch and she get free candy for me?
That is not the intention.
So I don't give her such a hard time. She's working really hard for us. You were listening?
Master Pastille, I do not think Syrup trusts in me. What should I do?
Don't worry, Gumdrop.
Once she sees you're a good person, I'm sure she'll come around. Right, Slut?
We'll see.
The next morning.
Gumdrop, what are you doing? Okay, this is where she rearranges the books.
I suddenly don't feel like it. Maybe I'll risk coming alone.
No! You've invested in this idea now. You have to let me come along. Am I going to get the butterscotch ending again? Wait a second. Does this have multiple... If I take this route, is it going to have multiple... It has to, right? One taste, that's it. How about you?
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah. So we're going back to Dragon Spine. She can deal. You should dress for the mother. This is what happens when you get overconfident.
Shut up! I'll make it! You need me for this, right?
I can't move this more! Time to go. Sauce at the pair, take a while to serve rest. Hey, you were right.
No! This is awful! I should have stayed home with Toffee where it's safe and warm.
Well, at least we should be able to find what we're looking for in here. It's that environment that Frosted Carmella drives in. You can just chill here if you want. I'm going further in. Okay. Take all you can carry? Yeah, I definitely never want to go on another trip like this with you, so I might as well make this one worth the effort. Alright. The magic the ice away so we can get out of here. Great. Take this! Nothing happened? But messing around and break the ice.
What if the wolves are still there?
I don't hear or see them. We should be fine.
Right! For real this time!
Something wrong.
I'm just stressed out! So my magic's not working! Shut up!
So we're trapped in here.
No, we're not trapped! I'm a great witch! This... It's just a stupid spell doesn't want to happen!
Okay, we're a little trapped. Magic is connected to your state of mind, right? Try to calm down.
I'm calm as frick!
Butterscotch.
I don't have the control. My emotions are completely in check and my magic should be working just fine.
Butterscotch.
What?
Talk to me. What's wrong?
I don't know.
It's cold if I can't get out. Okay, so this is the same. I click I hate you, I'm gonna feel really bad. But I already said I don't hate you. I'm gonna feel really bad about this. I have nothing to say to you.
Was there any other way out?
Bully that witch. I feel bad! Do you think I would've come back if there was? I can't believe you'd lie about literally everything just to make yourself look better. I should have never trusted you to come all the way here with me.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you better be sorry. We're gonna die here, all because you're too unstable to break us out.
How am I not either? Yelling at me isn't gonna make my magic suddenly work, you know?
Whatever. The air only seemed to get colder and colder in that cavern. Unable to reconcile little differences, this pair sat across from each other in silence. Bully that witch so stupid. Hours passed, and it was becoming difficult to stay conscious. Just before the two of them drifted off to sleep, they heard faint yet familiar voices just beyond the wall of ice. The trail ends here, at the suspicious looking ice formation. Which means we found them, right? If they're behind this thing, it might take some time. I ran out of voices. I've got nothing. Sorry, treat. It might take some time to break through. Don't worry, I'll take care of that.
Oh, I didn't realize you were... Great's cabin.
What happened?
Syrup has awoken. Thank goodness. Glad to see you're still alive. Promise me you'll never go off and do something this dangerous again.
What? Would you know where to find me?
As soon as I was able to move again, I rushed straight home to Master Pastille to inform him of your mission with Butterscotch. I am so sorry I could not keep the secret, but it was only because I was very worried you might end up frozen like I had been. I did not want that to happen to you.
It's a good thing she was in such a hurry, too. We almost didn't find you two in time. I warned you about the witch. You should have been more careful.
What matters is that Syrup is no longer unmoving. I can tell you that being frozen solid is very uncomfortable.
It's not as threatening for you, though. No matter how long you freeze, you'll be fine when you thaw out again. Humans don't have that advantage.
That is a very scary thought. Getting along with Syrup would be very tough if she could not come back from being frozen.
You're right. I'm really thankful you were in such a hurry to get me. Good work, Gumdrop.
Master Pastille is the one to thank, along with Miss Tree, for being so helpful.
Please don't put a miss in front of my name. Hold on, I got a question.
What is it?
I'm pretty sure that wall of ice would have taken way too long to break through normally. So, how'd you do it?
We managed somehow. Get some rest. We'll make you some soup, and once you're feeling up to it, we can head back, alright?
Yeah, sure. Hey.
Hey, I'm sorry. It's my fault we almost... I mean, if not for your friends...
It's okay. Don't worry about it. I want to apologize too for lashing out back there.
I understand. I would have been mad at me too. You don't need to apologize for anything. I'm the one who messed up.
Yeah, well, it all worked out in the end. Let's call it even and forget it ever happened, okay?
Okay.
As soon as Sharp felt up to it, everyone said goodbye to Treat and made their way home. Estiel heads back to the store on his own after Sharp decides to return Butterscotch to her cottage, followed by a fairy insisting Gumdrop.
Coffee, I'm home! Our mission was a success!
Your spell... Okay... It doesn't matter. I think I know what it might be, and I don't need to see it.
Lumi! Hi, Lumi!
You're in time for another game from the person who did Bed and Theta.
Is this by the same artist? Yes. Yes, it is.
Yes! I'm absolutely... Yes. I love those artists so much. Like, look at how cute this is.
What I really need is some sleep. Good night, Star.
Like, the art is so freaking cute!
Star had no trouble at all falling asleep that night. Whatever was on the crystal ball, she decided, wasn't important to her. The only thing that mattered was the ultimate suite.
Sailor Dream Candy Bowl. I didn't go straight for that ending at least.
Oh fuck, I didn't realize that was gonna... Well.
She changed. Why did she change?
Am I gonna have to do that all again because I just fucked up? Syrup, disinterested in people around her, put her into capitalism, now she's super rich.
Is that the ending I just got? Fuck. We're not to do that again. That's so much! She is ballin'!
I didn't realize that she wasn't gonna take it back to Butterscotch. Which, I mean, I guess tracks, but like... Yeah, like...
Wait, her portrait changed.
Okay, we're just gonna fast forward, hang on. We're skipping literally everything. We're just going through. I could do different options here, but we're not going to worry about it right now. We're doing all the same options we already did. I don't know if these little ones are going to change much, but... Okay.
So, how is it? It's the best thing I've ever tasted. Whoever came up with this recipe wasn't kidding about the ultimate part. I completely agree. I feel sort of bad that Gumdrop doesn't have any taste buds to experience this with. I am just happy to see the two of you enjoying it. I'm happy too. I thought you forgot about your promise to make this for me. I thank you. Don't start getting all sappy over nothing. Gumdrop's the one who reminded me. Serving Master Pastille is of the utmost importance. Shh, don't say things like that. You don't have to be so nice to me. He's right. If we're too soft, I'm going to stop working so hard. Unacceptable. I feel like you're not joking the slightest when you say that. Well, I just remembered something important I gotta do. See you around. She's in a hurry. I wonder if that wasn't just a lame excuse to run off. Do you actually have someplace to be? Syrup is a very mysterious person. Oh. Okay. So what do you say? Was a luxury treat this good? There's a ton of money to be made, don't you think? Most certainly, Canny Alchemist. By the sound of it, you're looking to us as investors for your little shop, eh? That's right. Came up with the idea last night. I make the candy, you guys fund and distribute the product, everybody gets richer. You would be fools to decline, considering this promising sample you provided us. What say you, brother? I concur. Candy Alchemist Syrup, we would be honored to do business with talent of your caliber. And with that, Syrup very quickly climbs the ladder of success, becoming one of the richest people in the world. With no distracting personal relationships to hold her back, she was able to live a glamorous life of self-indulging, providing deliciousness across many nations. If money could buy happiness, she's certainly done it. Way to go. Syrup and oh my god. The fact that she changed fucking outfits. That's so good. Easy money. This flavor text is strawberry. God, this is so good. This is such a cute game. This is so much fun. I've decided I really like this artist, this creator. And look, we've still got so many endings. 1, 2, 3, 4. What, 5 more endings? That I need to figure out how to get because I have no idea. Like, if I go through and I look in the crystal ball, that's not going to give me the butterscotch ending again, right? Because if I look in the crystal ball, she's going to see that Pastille made Gumdrop. It's like, is she going to feel betrayed by that? Oh, I know she feels betrayed because she mentions it, but like, does she act on it as one of the endings? Let's see, we done chased him off once. No, we chased him off twice. I'm wondering if we can chase him off a third time to get that last one. Like, that has to be another bad ending, right? Candy Bowl. You ate her. I can't believe you actually ate her. Let's see. I wonder if there's a way if we just kind of... You can eat the candy for... You want to see it? It's bad. It sounds... It's bad. Hang on, Lumi. We can do that ending again. I don't know if Mario's still here, but, like... Yes! Okay. A peaceful town of magic users, there's a shop that only sells ordinary, non-magical candies. Altier Sweets. I'm here for... The owner is known as the Candy Alchemist, a firm believer in science as the superior art. Proud and stubborn, she continues to make magnificent candies in order to prove her case. But a magical surprise waits in her basement workshop. What's this saying? Good morning. How are you today? Fine. I am also fine. Estelle, can you come down here? Like, now? I would like it if you told me your name. I would tell you mine, but I was not given one. Syrup. Pastille, hurry up! You are Syrup. It is very nice to meet you. I hope we can be friends. Yeah, that's not happening. Pastille, get down here already!
Syrup, it is very important that we get along.
A random naked candy girl showing up in your house is the most anime. Trust me, it's gonna get weird here in a second.
You stay away from me. I want you out of my lap right now. What is this you are holding?
What's it look like? It's candy.
You are eating it?
Yep.
That's the whole point of candy.
You get eaten.
I see. Then, please eat me.
What? No, you weirdo.
But you have to. It is my purpose. As candy.
No, she says please eat me once, and then she doesn't drop it. Like, she keeps going back. So will you eat me now?
That's an ending I haven't done. Giving her the butterscotch and then helping Castile get her back. I haven't done that one yet.
Do what you want. In that case, Naked Candy Girl asks you to eat her Lumi. Do you do it? And then explain why the answer is yes. In that case.
Even if you're human-shaped and alive, you do look pretty delicious. Did you need me for something, Sai?
No, I changed my mind. Go back upstairs.
Oh, we have a guest. Made of candy?
I'm not sharing, so don't even ask.
Okay. I'll just get back to work then?
In my defense, I was dying of starvation and I've been 8 hours.
Good. All right, candy girl. Time to see what you're made of.
You ready for this?
Your insides are pretty realistic, though it doesn't seem like your organs actually function. You're 100% magic powered, aren't you? I do not know the details of my biology. Does it hurt when I pull things out like this? No, I was not designed to feel pain. Do you know where the parts of your body came from? Because most of this candy looks like mine, except covered in gross magic.
Hey, who made you anyway?
That is a secret. Sorry to intrude. I brought you two some drinks. What? Candy biopsy. Trying to figure out which part I want to eat first. How could you? Sai, you can't just eat someone.
You told me to.
So if I told you to eat me, would you?
That's different.
It's not.
You're anyway.
Listen, Pastio. I got this walking amalgamation of deliciousness all laid out, literally asking me to eat it. So I'm going to eat it. It doesn't matter what she's made of. I can't believe you'd just eat a person. Don't you have a heart? You want me to answer that? I can't. I don't think I can deal with this. It's too much. You've already decided on this, haven't you? Fine. I don't want to believe it. But you turned out to be a lost cause after all. Do what you want. I'm leaving. It really does take a while to eat a person's body weight in candy, huh? All of you taste so good. I should try making another one of you myself. Without magic, of course. I wonder if I could do it. Imagine how much I could sell something like this for, too. Syrup, are we friends?
Huh? What do you care? You're just candy.
Oh, I see. Speaking of friends, where the heck is Pastille? Some of his stuff is missing, and he hasn't come in since a couple days ago now. I can't believe he's throwing such a huge fit over this. That kid is so fired. Syrup continued to eat the candy girl until she was no more. After countless attempts to create another, she was forced to give up when her store was close to declining sales. Pastille never returned. Cannibalian.
Yeah, fired. I love how she still talks to you as you eat her. It is disturbing. Cannibal. I do love the name of it though, yes.
Oh, this game is like,
it's so good. It is so good.
Her fault for being a snack. You know, normally when you call someone a snack, you don't literally eat them. I'm just saying.
But yeah, you can eat the candy girl.
You know what we should do? Samix isn't the one who should have a whole stream going, yeah. And it should be Lumina. Lumina, you should totally have a whole stream going, yeah.
Patrice, you know,
Lumenya,
would you have a whole stream where you make a bunch of cat puns?
Oh my god.
Please? Lumenya? I guess I can, yeah, a little as a treat. Hey, thank you. I appreciate it.
Next time you play Hades, just go, yeah, just sporadically. It specifically has to be when you're playing Hades. Just do a Nami stream instead of uwu.
You know, like, yeah.
Golden ring, yeah. Oh my.
You know, like, yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna agree to help him because I haven't done that yet. I still kind of like, I don't know, I'm not big on like Souls likes, but I am tempted to try Elden Ring still. Read up. All right, if it's that important to save some lump of candy, I'll help you out.
Thank you.
Oh, okay, she's really cute with the short hair though.
Everybody take a s'more, more delicious. Candy this good must be a sin. Miss Butterscotch, if you continue eating that leg, soon I will not be able to walk anymore.
People expect the serious stream and it's just millions kicking my ass.
Yeah.
Please, Lumi. Lumi, please. Lumi, please. Lumi, I need this. You don't understand. Hey.
How rude. You didn't even wipe your feet before barging in here, yeah?
Stuff it, cat. I'm taking back my golem.
What? This thing was a gift, no take backs.
Apex? What are you, three? This isn't playground rules. I changed my mind about letting you keep this golem, so now we're leaving. That's that. I'm okay with her kicking my
Syrup.
Ugh, you're all sticky. Sorry for letting that witch slob all over you. Let's get out of here.
Nya, I think you were pretty cool if it weren't for all the mean stuff you did to Master Nya.
Yeah, well, you guys damaged my stuff, so I guess we're even. Later.
Oh, I can't stand her! There's still so much left to eat! She can make her own candy. Why should she bully me like this? Maybe she wanted to taste the golem after your lips were on it. Indirect kisses, yeah.
Don't make her stop me. I mean, what? Syrup took the candy girl back to her workshop and began replacing all the parts Butterscotch had eaten away. It wasn't long before she was back to mint condition. They decided to leave her hair as it was, after Syrup had mentioned it looked kind of cute. It is cute, though. But we all know... Look, I don't know anything about Elden Rings, except that Marion do like it. It is cute. Right? The short hair is adorable. And so the golem started living with Syrup and Pestilat at all to her sweets. She came a mask and figure, boosting sales.
Oh, do we get the same scenes, only with short hair now? You'll think of something. I have faith in you, Syrup.
Going on over here. I'm trying to come up with a name for it. Oh, her hair is just short now. That's cute.
You're naming her? What happened to candy golems aren't pets?
Okay. So we named her Gumdrop. All of this is going to be the same, I think. I'm leaving.
You're going out today. What would I have left sooner if I hadn't gotten caught up talking to everyone? Thanks for that. All right, enjoy the sunshine.
Maybe it'll make you a little less grouchy. Don't count on it. What do we do? They're here for the... Is this any different? Get ready for some disappointment. Oh, yeah. If you only came along to see me with your stupid punks and go home.
Matilda.
No, we both have... You're joking, right? Which I also made, but trading golems. Okay, Gumdrop bad. Too bad she's working for me. She's my thing.
You even replace all her parts so I can join them all over again, right? Right? No, I don't want anyone eating her again. It was kind of messed up.
Huh?
It's just candy. Listen, I'm not trading Gumdrop for your dummy candy doll, so quit hanging around here and scaring off her.
If we make a purchase, you'll forgive us.
What you do to words is unforgivable.
Meowch.
Am I some more candy?
Okay. That would be candy napping, yeah? Syrup, have they returned to taste the new limbs you made for me?
They're just buying some candy. I won't let them touch you.
I do not like these customers.
Oof, this is pain in my chest. Hearing her say that kind of hurts somehow. Is it a curse? She do magic too.
I think what you're feeling is guilt, yeah? Looks like she really didn't appreciate you eating her up before.
Didn't you say that was your purpose as candy, though?
I only want to be eaten by Syrup. That's not fair! And I'm sorry if I treated you kind of bad, but why does Syrup get to eat you when I can't?
I'm not eating her. She's just confused, I think. Now she's traumatized because of you two, so hurry up and buy something so you can leave. I just want to get rid of us. But fine, whatever. Are you okay?
He is not going to eat me. No, I am fine.
If she hurts you, it's okay to hate her, you know?
Syrup, do you dislike Miss Butterscotch?
This is the game that makes me want to draw my other OC again. Do it, do it, do it. Lumi, Lumi, let's go.
Switch. Is this all the same?
I think this is going to be the same.
Gives it, gives it. Yes! all the same.
Even someone who did something that hurt you, why would you want that unless you're still taking orders?
But those are my feelings. I won't give her such a hard time. What should I do?
We'll see. The next morning. Okay, actually this part's funny.
Oh, Syrup. I am organizing your bookshelf.
Why? What are you even doing up right now? The store doesn't open for another few hours.
I do not require sleep.
Anyway, you shouldn't come down here without permission to start moving my things around. I don't like it.
Oh, may I come in and...
You already did! But whatever, I guess it's fine.
Syrup, I have noticed a trend with books in your personal library.
This part, it's actually funny, wait.
Oh yeah? What's that?
They're all very boring!
Yay, thanks! Only one book is abnormal. It's the only one with reference to magic.
Reversed it. I thought that was great.
And then... This is, they go to make the others won't let her help out. She can deal. I don't want to be too nice to her.
Yeah, I don't want to be too nice to her and then... Because I don't want the butterscotch ending again. And I don't know if that's going to get me the butterscotch ending. This is the part where it's like, if I look into the crystal ball... This is the part where I'm not sure if that's going to... Okay, let me save right here. Actually. I forgot I could do that until just now. Ponder the orb! Okay, I really need to figure out how skipping in this game works. Rookie Fian mistakes, not saving a choice. Look! I forgot that that was an option. It's been a minute since I played a visual novel, okay?
You know what we should play? We should do Hustle Cat. Hustle Cat's a cute one.
I still want to do Clannad too. At some point in time. Check options, it might be set to skip all. I'd love to look at it says unseen text. I don't know. So should I just do after choice? I don't know. Like this doesn't exactly explain where it skips to. Puzzle Cat is so cute though. Yes, Lumi, absolutely. Puzzle Cat is fantastic.
What I think, okay, admittedly, I tried to get different characters and I think I ended up with, what's her name again? I forgot what her name is. Is it Finn? This little cat characters. Finley, yeah. I ended up with Finley like three separate times. I love Hustlecat. Hustlecat is so cute. Like I got all of them and the secret route. Ooh, so what I'm hearing is that you'll do a stream with me, Lumi, to help me get more than just Finley, because I kept going back to Finley. Hustlecat is so cute. Ugh. I didn't know there was a secret ending. That's great. Lol, yes, please. Okay, Hustlecat stream win. We need to figure this out. I want to do a Hustlecat stream. Okay, anyway, so we return. We're just going to look at the history for right now. Or no. I did just save, so. Look into the crystal orb. It's a lot easier on Sundays, but I can try on Monday. Okay. We can figure it out. Like, if I needed to move stuff around, because I've been doing Genshin on Sunday. Well, this week I didn't, because I refuse to do Wind Trace. But we all know Mason is best girl. I just really liked Finley for some reason. You alive now? Mason! Hello, Master. Is it you come in? Right, okay. So I should read all this again. I don't feel like reading all this again, but I also don't want to skip because it just took me back over to her, so. It's gonna click really fast for a minute. It's fine. This is fine. Everything's fine. I suppose I should go return this. Alright. Yeah. Something like this, putting on a show, da da da. Oh yeah, so this is coffee gets called out and it's like, wow. Don't heal, is it? Best thing I ever tasted. Okay. I do absolutely love how we're just getting these scenes with short hair now. She looks so cute with short hair. I was supposed to face that witch after everything that happened. We agreed to forget it, but that doesn't promise there won't be any awkwardness. Ooh, okay, yeah, this is different, so. Last time she just went back to the cabin, and that's how I got the butterscotch ending. Kinda wish that cat was here to take care of it for me. Meow, is that? Candy Alchemist is requesting my services? I knew you'd come out if I talked to myself loud enough. Impressive! So how long were you wandering around saying those lines and places you'd expect me to be, Meow? That's not important. Can you do me this favor? Sure thing. But you'll have to do something in return, yeah? I'm already offering the ultimate sweet. What more could you want? I want you to take me up to Mount Sorbet to thank the dog for saving Master. Going alone isn't an option for obvious reasons. Yeah. Oh, Toffee. That's it. What a polite familiar you turned out to be. Master's important to me, and I want to show my gratitude. Will you do it or not? Of course. Yeah, I'll help you out. Really? Thanks, Nya. I'll grab my winter coat and we can go right away. That time was unintentional. I've been unstoppable, Nya. I love Toffee. Love Toffee. Same Toffee. Toffee's so good. I'm already regretting this decision.
However, Toffee easily convinced Syrup to follow through with their deal after promising to remain silent until they reached Treat's house.
I didn't expect you to return so soon.
I wasn't planning on it, to be honest, but Toffee here was too afraid to come alone, so...
Oh yes, a cat like me shouldn't be bothered whatsoever coming to a place like this. Sure turned out to be the wrong person to ask this favor for, yeah.
I'm just giving you a hard time. Say your thing already. Are you her pet?
I'm the witch's familiar. I just wanted to thank you for saving Master. But how could you think I belong to Syrup? I'm a little insulted, yeah?
The two of you seem like you get along. My mistake. Let me set the record straight. This cat works for my rival. They're an obnoxious duo set on sabotaging my business. That's what I would say, if not for certain recent offense. Toby's not bad, I don't think.
Gee whiskers! Such flattering praise. Anyway, now that my business here is finished, it's time to head home. Thanks again, yeah.
Huh? You just got here. I won't let you leave without a warm drink for the road. Wait here.
I wonder.
Are you nervous?
She's a wolf. Of course I'm nervous. She couldn't eat me in a second, yeah?
It's funny to see you showing your true emotions. Oh my god, Talby is so cute! Sorry, see, you like this makes me want to bully you. But don't worry, if she does try to eat you, which she won't, I'll stop her.
Oh no, just let it happen. I wouldn't want anyone to assume we're getting along.
Are you that upset she got the wrong impression?
Hi, I'm back, what happened? Toffee's being cute.
Hey, would it really be that bad to be my pet?
Absolutely!
Ouch, what did I ever do to you?
First off, I'm Master's pet and no one else's, so you don't have a chance from the start. But even putting that aside, you don't know a thing about me.
Toffee's always cute. Toffee's great. I know that you're a cat who lives with Butterscotch and that you make puns all the time for attention.
For attention? Perhaps I underestimated you, Candy Alchemist. But answer this. Do you think I am a boy? Or a girl, Nya?
I feel like there's a wrong choice here. The answer is yes. That's what I want to say. Like, I don't know. What do you want me to click, Toffee? What am I picking boy or girl? I know, I've played these games before. Should I pick boy or girl? Which one do I pick though? Like, what do I pick though? Like, I don't know which one I pick though. A or B? Save and do both. Once again, I forgot saving was an option. The answer is cat. I'm just gonna overwrite that, yeah.
Wait. Yeah, that was a trick question. The correct answer is neither.
Ah! Nom nom nommy. Wonder she with these choices.
I just always assumed. Well, I guess that's actually more fitting for you anyway.
Ayo, you're familiar? Let's go.
But thanks for telling me. Now you can say I don't know anything about you. Yeah, I shouldn't have given you the answer so easily. You're sneaky, Candy Alchemist. Now I have one more question for you, Nya. See, I noticed something. You don't seem very close to anyone in particular.
Ah, so the answer is no, not yes. Apparently.
But now you're showing an unusual amount of interest in me. Are you just pulling my tail here? Are you actually trying to become my friend?
Who knows?
I just thought maybe having a cat would be nice. I never expected to hear something like that from you.
I started adjusting my attitude recently.
How do you feel about the new me? I don't like it at all. You're not as predictable now, Nya.
Here, it's milk.
My favorite! How thoughtful, Nya. Thank you very much.
Oh. You seem to have calmed down a lot. That's good. Turns out all they needed was for me to pet them for a while.
You're cute!
Toffee's adorable! And so Syrup and Toffee started spending a lot of time together. And Toffee began calling themselves a part-time pet. Oh my god, that's cute though! Part-time pet! Oh my god!
Life at Altair Suites continued on as normal, except for the addition of a store cat. Buttersquatch never quite got over the jealousy of her pet getting stolen away, but other than that, they all lived happily ever after.
I love Butterscotch in the window, right? She's like, you took my cat.
You took my cat.
Why did you take my cat?
Coffee and...
Yeah.
That's cute! That one was so good. That's adorable.
Oh, I was kind of hoping she'd cut her hair. Because, like, where she changed, I guess because we didn't get the gumdrop end. I wonder if they changed. Well, no, because we got the toffee and butterscotch, and neither of them changed either. Why did you change? No, she stays fresh, apparently. Zerpadoff's coughs, she has her pet.
Yeah.
Coffee lets it happen, dude. That was cute.
Okay, so there's a serpent, which means there's gotta be a pastille and a gumdrop end, right? So that's gotta be what those two are. And I'm telling you, there's another bad ending. But I don't have any idea what this one might be then. Do we wanna keep going to find out? We very much wanna keep going to find out, honestly. But it is also starting to get late. And if I want to attempt to fix my sleep schedule, because I'm still tired. Like, I took a nap earlier, but, like, it didn't do
as much as I was hoping. Excuse me.
I don't think I can get through another ending in, like, 15 minutes, can I? Decisions. I was kind of hoping she'd keep her hair cut, though.
Yeah.
Decisions. I'll probably go ahead and call it soon, and hopefully I'll get to sleep, you know, before 6 a.m. this time. We can try. So, on that note... Let's see, that's a big person I follow. There's no way in hell I'm doing that. That's a big person I follow. There's no way in hell I'm doing that. Ooh. Are we in a Pokemon?
Oh my god, stay. What is the sleep schedule? Yeah, look, okay. So I just could not sleep last night to save my life. I've been doing the 6 or 7 a.m. bedtime this weekend. And that is not healthy. We all need to work on that. Last night was just a really bad bout of insomnia. So, like, I did not fall asleep till, like, well after 6. And then I was up by, like, I want to say I fell asleep about 6:30. And then I was up by about 10:30. And then I took a nap, but I'm still pretty tired, so. Excuse me. Now that I've acknowledged it, I can't stop yawning. So, oh my god. Look, I tried. It wasn't working. Hey, Lumi.
Hi, everyone. Oh! Hello, General, what? Hubby, you bee.
I was just thinking about wrapping it, but... Why?
I didn't think about stopping because I'm tired, but now I kind of want to do another ending, but I don't know if there's another ending I can get really easy.
I was playing Pokemon and suddenly it was 7 a.m.
Excuse me.
Oh, once upon a time, and where was it? Sorry, it must not have been very memorable. I love the flavor text at the bottom. What do you be how Pokemon can be?
E.
Speaking of Pokemon,
Someone who did, or the person who did the ending theme that I use is doing Pokemon Arceus right now. I might just go ahead and rate them since Pokemon got brought up. If that's okay. Ooh, yee. It's like I acknowledged that I was tired and now I'm yawning, so otherwise I might have considered going some more. Because I'm really enjoying this. Like, do you guys want to see the rest of the endings, or should I go ahead and just do it off stream? Because I was thinking, thanks for streaming. Yeah, thanks for stopping. I know it was only right there at the end. I'm sorry about that. But thank you for stopping. I appreciate it. We'll decide. I can decide later if I just want to finish that off stream and move on to the next game or what. I don't know. Figure it out later. But hey. I will be back tomorrow with Omori because it is Tuesday. We will continue the Hikikomori route. Gloomy, I need to play this game. I'm getting more people to play this game, I swear to God. Ah, see you later. You can always do them off stream and showcase your heroes. Ooh, true. And that way, we can go ahead and do another game biome later. I've got a few of them on here. They're really cute. I was enjoying it. Like, I want to do the treat series now. And, like, her tears were my light or next up, so I might just finish up and do that. But, okay. Yeah, thank you guys for hanging out with me for a while. I hope you had a decent time watching me be really bad at doing voices for a visual novel. We can come back to another visual novel. I don't think Omori counts as a visual novel, but it's close! Yes, play all and then read the spicy comics. The spicy comics I'd have to do on, like, Discord or off stream. But, okay. Anyway. Ayo! Look, they've got 18 plus comics to do! But okay. Yeah, I will talk to you guys. If you show up tomorrow, just to say hi, feel free. I'm gonna be fighting bears for at least the first half hour, so. And I'll talk to you.